BGMC. The biblical truth lives here.
Ancient Hebrew scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His Word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
What we're going to be doing here tonight
lo que vamos a hacer hoy día
is understanding why we should celebrate Hanukkah.
Es entender por qué estamos celebrando Hanukkah.
We go to the second slide there, Martin. That's just the. Is it the whole? Did Veronica translate the whole PowerPoint?
The one that you sent last night, yes.
Oh, she did the whole thing. So turn to 1 Corinthians 3, please.
Vamos a Primera de Corintios 3.
1 Corinthians 3.
Primera de Corintios 3.
Verse 16 and 17.
Versículo 16 y 17.
1 Corinthians 3, verse 16 and 17. We're going to start out there for our Hanukkah understanding.
Vamos a empezar ahí para el entendimiento de Hanukkah.
1 Corinthians 3, verse 16 and 17.
Primera de Corintios, capítulo 3, versículo 16 y 17.
When you got it, say amen. Amen. Don't you know that you people are God's temple, and a God's spirit lives in you? So if anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him, for God's temple is holy, and you yourselves are that temple. Okay? The temple has parts.
El templo tiene partes.
And if you're God's temple,
y si tú eres el templo de Dios,
you must have an altar inside of you.
Debes que tú vas a tener un altar dentro de ti.
Because you're going to offer things up to God in the spirit.
Porque te vas a ofrecer cosas al Señor en espíritu.
Okay, so what Rav Shaul is talking about here,
lo que el Rabino Shaul está hablando aquí,
that God's Spirit lives inside you.
Que el Espíritu de Dios vive dentro de ti.
But sometimes during our lives,
pero muchas veces durante nuestras vidas,
things in our lives get a little bit messed up.
Las cosas en nuestras vidas a veces se complican un poco.
Sometimes we make mistakes.
A veces cometemos errores.
Has anybody ever made mistakes?
¿Alguien ha cometido errores?
That you've regretted and you want to repent to the Lord.
¿Te has dado cuenta y te quieres arrepentirte ante el Señor?
Okay, well, you need an altar for that.
Necesitas un altar para eso.
And we have a heart.
Y tenemos nuestros corazones.
Okay, which is your altar.
Que es tu altar.
Okay, because a lot of times your heart tells your head what to do.
Porque muchas de las veces tu corazón te dice por adelantado lo que tienes
que hacer. Has anybody ever had that happen?
¿Alguien le ha pasado?
Where your head is telling you don't do it.
Cuando tu cabeza te está diciendo no
lo
hagas.
Your head is telling you don't do it.
Tu cabeza dice no lo hagas.
Okay, you can equate it to the Bugs Bunny thing.
Tú puedes ver lo que dice Bugs Bunny.
For some of us, you have the two little gremlins on your shoulders.
Tienes esas dos criaturas pequeñas en tus hombros.
The good gremlin and the bad gremlin.
El ángel bueno y el ángel malo.
And that's what Shaul is really talking about.
Y es de esto lo que el Rabino Shaul está hablando.
You're God's temple.
Tú eres el templo de Dios.
So if you have a temple,
si tú tienes el templo,
that means you have an altar that is inside your temple.
Eso significa que tienes un altar que está dentro del templo.
And your head is like, the Kohanim.
Y tu cabeza es el sumo sacerdote.
And your heart is like the Spirit of God that lives inside you.
Y tu corazón es el Espíritu de Dios que vive dentro de ti.
And if we look at verse 17,
si miras el versículo 17,
so if anybody destroys God's temple, God will destroy him. For God's temple is holy, and you yourselves are that temple. So at the end of verse 17,
al final del versículo 17,
he's saying that you are that temple.
Dice que tú eres ese templo.
And you destroy yourselves.
Y tú te destruiste por ti mismo.
But the beautiful thing about our God,
lo más hermoso de nuestro Dios,
the beautiful thing about our God,
lo más hermoso de nuestro Dios,
is He is the God of chesed, mercy.
Es un Dios de misericordia.
As we talked about this morning,
como hablamos en esta
mañana. He does not want to destroy you.
Él no quiere destruirte.
That's why we're looking at Hanukkah again tonight.
Es por eso que estamos mirando otra vez a Hanukkah.
Because he wants you to rededicate your temple to his purposes.
Él quiere que redediques tu templo para sus propósitos.
So hear what Rav Shaul is saying.
Aquí vemos al Rabino Shaul diciendo.
He's reminding us that we are the temple of God.
Nos está recordando que nosotros somos el templo de Dios.
He's reminding us.
Nos está recordando.
That anybody who destroys that temple.
Que todo aquel que destruye el templo.
Now what's the most important of this part of the temple?
¿Cuál es lo más importante de la parte del templo?
Is that altar.
Es ese altar.
That you bring to God.
Que lo traes al Señor.
You bring to God an offering.
Le traes al Señor las ofrendas.
What do you bring that? What do you put? Where do you put that offering?
¿Dónde vas a poner esa ofrenda?
So that's what Hanukkah is about.
De eso se trata Hanukkah.
Because each year we make mistakes.
Cada año cometemos errores.
And the Lord is the Lord of second chances.
El Señor es un Dios de dos chances, de dos oportunidades.
Okay, because one, you have Yom Kippur.
Que la primera tienes Yom Kippur.
But now with Hanukkah,
pero ahora con Hanukkah,
in a specific part of the temple,
en una parte específica del templo,
because here with Yom Kippur,
porque aquí en Yom Kippur,
you cleanse the whole temple.
Tú limpias todo el templo.
But then during the year we have these mistakes.
Pero durante este año, el año, tú cometes más errores.
So this is what Shaul is talking about in 1 Corinthians 3.
De eso es lo que el Rabino Shaul está hablando en la primera de Corintios 3.
If you learn anything about Hanukkah tonight,
si aprendes algo de Hanukkah hoy día,
learn
hoy noche,
that you are the temple.
Aprende que tú eres el templo.
You are the temple because there is no temple in Israel yet.
Porque no hay templo aún en Israel.
And for 2,000 years, there has been no temple.
Y por 2,000 años no ha habido templo.
So then you must be the temple of God.
Entonces tú deberías ser el templo de Dios.
And time after time, we defile our altar.
Y por muchas veces contaminamos el altar.
Now what's going to happen?
¿Qué es lo que va a pasar?
What's going to happen?
¿Qué es lo que va a pasar?
God's going to destroy that temple.
El Señor va a destruir ese templo.
Unless you fix it.
A no ser que tú lo arregles.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima.
Does Yeshua celebrate Hanukkah?
Yeshua celebra Hanukkah.
Does Yeshua celebrate Hanukkah?
Yeshua celebra Hanukkah.
And well, we see in John 10, verse 22 and 23, if you want to turn to John 10, 22.
Vemos en Juan 10, versículo 22. Abramos.
John 10.
En Juan 10.
Verse 22 and 23.
Versículo 22 y 23.
John 10. Yochanan 10,
Juan 10,
verse 22 and 23.
Versículo 22 y 23.
Now we had a very good discussion this afternoon. We're going to go over it again.
Tuvimos una.
Because you have to know how to read what you're seeing.
Porque tienes que saber dónde vas a estar si pecas.
Then came Hanukkah in Yerushalayim. It was winter, and Yeshua was walking around inside the temple area in Shlomo's colonnade. Okay, so first let's look at the word Hanukkah.
Primeramente vamos a mirar la palabra Hanukkah.
It was dedication time in Yerushalayim.
Era un tiempo de dedicación en Jerusalén.
So here it is, a memorial feast.
Aquí vemos que es una fiesta memorable.
We then see the second half of verse 22.
Hasta ahora vemos la segunda parte del versículo 22.
It gives us, it's winter.
Nos está diciendo que es invierno.
So this is different than the dedication of the temple, which is in the seventh month.
Esto es diferente a la dedicación del templo, que es en el séptimo mes.
Each word is very significant and very important.
Cada palabra tiene mucho significado y muy importante.
Now, here and now in verse 23, let's read verse 23.
Leamos el versículo 23.
And Yeshua was walking around inside the temple area in Shlomo's colonnade. What was he doing?
¿Qué estaba haciendo Yeshua?
What was he doing?
¿Qué estaba haciendo?
He was inspecting.
Él estaba inspeccionando.
He was inspecting the temple.
Estaba inspeccionando el templo.
He was inspecting the sheep.
Estaba inspeccionando las ovejas.
Because if you read all of John 10,
porque si lees todo Juan 10,
it goes on to talk about the sheep.
Va a terminar cuando está hablando de las ovejas.
It goes on to talk about the sheep's gate.
Va a hablar de las puertas de las ovejas.
So here we see in verse 22,
aquí vemos en el versículo 22,
it's the feast of dedication,
es la fiesta de la dedicación,
in Jerusalem or Yerushalayim.
En Jerusalén.
It was winter.
Era invierno.
So we know that it is a differentiation between that and Sukkot.
Es una diferencia entre Sukkot.
And we see Yeshua experiencing
y vemos que
the
Yeshua
temple.
Está experimentando el templo.
What was he just going, hey dude, look at the temple?
Estaba solo mirando el templo.
He was walking around.
Él estaba caminando alrededor.
To see if there was sin going on.
Para ver si hay pecado. En el templo.
He was inspecting his father's house.
Estaba inspeccionando la casa de su padre.
Because during dedication, Hanukkah,
durante la dedicación, Hanukkah,
you inspect everything. You inspect the temple.
Tú pasas inspección por todo el templo.
He's inspecting. He's the inspector general.
Él está inspeccionando el templo.
Because we know that he says, this is my father's house.
Porque vemos que él dice, esta es la casa de mi padre.
And remember when he gets really mad and he flips the tables, right?
Recuerda cuando él se enojó y echó todas las mesas.
So here he is. It is Hanukkah.
Vemos aquí que es Hanukkah.
Okay, it's dedication time.
Es el tiempo de dedicación.
Now what is happening during dedication? What would one do?
¿Qué es lo que pasa en la dedicación? ¿Qué estuviera haciendo Juan?
If you're dedicating something.
Si estás dedicando algo.
You're dedicating something to the Lord. What do you do?
Si estás dedicando algo al Señor, ¿qué harías tú?
You inspect it.
Tú inspeccionas.
You know, you want to give your Pesach offering. What do you do?
Tú cuando vayas a dar la ofrenda de Pesach, ¿qué es lo
what
que
did we do with the, when we went to go look for the lamb, right?
¿Qué se hace cuando se va a buscar el,
I inspected
el cordero?
I said to the guy, can you open up his mouth? He goes, what?
Se inspecciona, se le dice que le abra la boca.
I want to be a dentist. I don't know. Open up the mouth.
Quiero ser un dentista. Ábrale la boca.
Right? Didn't I do that?
Yes.
Okay. And then what else do I do?
¿Qué más tú,
he spin him around. Why?
Le hizo caminar,
I'm looking for blemishes.
Estoy buscando
because
por defectos.
I'm going to offer that for our congregation to the Lord.
Porque voy a ofrecer en nuestra congregación para el Señor.
So Yeshua here is during Hanukkah.
Aquí vemos a Yeshua durante
he's
Hanukkah.
Inspecting the temple. He's walking around.
Él está inspeccionando el templo. Está caminando alrededor.
He's looking to see if there's blemishes on the altar.
Está viendo si hay culpabilidad en el templo.
He's looking to see if there's bad things going on in his temple.
Está viendo si hay alguna cosa mala en su templo.
Okay, now remember the chapter sequence is very important. I'm only doing part of it.
Recuerda la secuencia del capítulo es muy importante. Solo voy a hacer una parte.
Okay, I'm only doing part of the chapter before for time purposes again tonight.
Voy a hacer solo partes por propósitos de tiempo.
But if you look at last year's message,
pero si miras el mensaje del año
pasado, I read
pasado,
all of John 10.
Yo leí todo Juan 10.
Okay, he's talking about the sheep. The sheep know my voice.
Está hablando de las ovejas. Las ovejas conocen mi voz.
Do you know God's voice?
¿Conoces tú la voz de Dios?
Hanukkah is all about knowing His voice.
Hanukkah se trata todo de reconocer su voz.
Because once we read what has happened right before this,
una vez vamos a leer lo que está pasando antes
de esto. Less than 200 years before this,
200 años antes de esto,
Israel has been conquered time and time again.
Israel ha sido conquistado otras veces.
And once again, they are not under self-rule.
Una vez no están bajo
self-governance.
Su propio gobierno.
Self-governance. They're not under self-governance.
No están bajo su propio gobierno.
So Yeshua here is definitively celebrating the feast of Hanukkah.
Yeshua aquí está celebrando la fiesta de Hanukkah.
Because when did Shlomo dedicate the temple?
Porque cuando
what month was that?
Salomón dedicó el templo.
Seventh month.
Septimus.
Seventh month.
Septimus.
Okay, we're going to read Chronicles later.
Vamos a leer crónicas más tarde.
So he's definitively not just walking around looking for a cigarette.
Está caminando en busca de un
cigarrillo. Anybody got a cigarette?
¿Alguien tiene un cigarrillo?
So he's walking around.
Él está caminando alrededor.
Okay, you got one? All right. All right, there you go. Let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
The order is very important to the chapters.
El orden es muy importante en los capítulos.
Let's look now at verse 10 through 12. Chapter 10, verse 11 and 12, I'm
vamos
sorry.
Vamos a ver ahora Juan 10 del 11, versículo 11.
John chapter 10, 11 y 12.
Versículo 11 y 12.
11 and 12 for those who don't speak Spanish.
11 y 12.
You speak Spanish? Oh, cool. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, since he isn't a shepherd and the sheep aren't his own, sees the wolf coming and abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf drags them off and scatters them. Amen? So here, right before Hanukkah,
aquí, antes de Hanukkah,
Yeshua is talking about being a shepherd.
Yeshua está hablando de ser un pastor.
Laying his life down for God's cause.
Poniendo su propia vida por a causa de Dios.
Once we get to the book of Maccabees.
Una vez que vayamos a ver el libro de los Macabeos.
You're going to see that the Maccabees, the family of the Maccabees, Levites.
Vas a ver que la familia de los Macabeos, los Levitas.
Lay their life down for God's purpose.
Entregan su vida por los propósitos de Dios.
So without a shadow of a doubt, if you know that information.
Esto es un shadow.
Without a preponderance, a question at all.
Esto es, estaba preguntándose.
Without a question at all.
Sin duda.
You know that in John 10, verse 22 and 23.
Vemos en Juan 10, versículo 22 y 23.
You know that he's talking about Hanukkah and he's celebrating it.
Estamos viendo que él está hablando de Hanukkah y está celebrando.
Because he's saying, I'm going to lay my life down for my Father's kingdom.
Porque él dice que voy a entregar mi vida. Por el reino de mi padre.
Some other people that don't care at all.
Muchas personas no les importa.
They see the wolves coming.
Ellos ven que los lobos vienen.
And they don't care.
Y no les importa.
Well, it's not mine. I'm just going to run away. I'm going to save my own life.
No son míos y no les importa. Voy a salvar mi propia vida.
But once you understand Hanukkah.
Pero una vez que entiendes Hanukkah.
And why Yeshua is celebrating it in verse 22 and 23.
Y por qué Yeshua está celebrando en el versículo 22 y 23.
You will absolutely understand.
Tú vas a entender.
That he is celebrating.
Que él está celebrando.
Because he's referencing it in verse 11 and 12.
Porque él está haciendo referencia en el versículo 11 y 12.
Because the good shepherd.
Porque el buen pastor.
Lays down his life for the sheep.
Da su vida por las ovejas.
Now, when we were talking earlier and during Road to Emmaus.
Lo que estábamos hablando temprano.
We spoke about Hanukkah a little further.
Hablamos un poco de Hanukkah.
And we see Mattathias, Maccabee.
Vimos a Mattathias, Macabeo.
He lays down his life.
Él entrega su vida.
To win back God's temple, to fight evil.
Para ganar el templo de Dios, para pelear al mal.
He was willing to lose everything.
Él estuvo dispuesto a perder todo.
To fight for God's temple.
Para pelear por el templo de Dios.
He was willing to fight against a society that was part of Rome.
Él estuvo dispuesto a pelear con la sociedad que era parte de Roma.
He watched other Jewish people dedicating their lives to the Roman gods.
Él miraba a otra gente judía que estaban dedicando sus vidas a los imperios romanos.
Now we looked at verse 22 and 23 first.
A los dioses romanos. Vemos ahora el versículo 22 y 23.
We see Yeshua in the temple.
Vemos a Yeshua en el templo.
During Hanukkah, the dedication.
Durante Hanukkah, la dedicación.
But that's after this part of John.
Pero eso es después de esta parte de Juan.
Laying down your life for God's purposes is what he wants us to do.
Lo que quiere es que entreguemos nuestras vidas para los propósitos de Dios.
Going on to the next slide.
Próxima página.
And let's go to verse 17 now.
Vamos al versículo 17.
Verse 17.
Versículo 17.
This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. Amen. Okay, what we're going to see in the book of Maccabees.
Vamos a ver en el libro de los Macabeos.
Is laying down our lives.
Él está poniendo su vida.
Against everything else in society.
En contra de todo lo que es la sociedad.
So Yeshua is referencing that before he gets to Hanukkah.
Yeshua está haciendo referencia antes de llegar a Hanukkah.
And the Father, when the Father loves you.
Y cuando el Padre te ama.
He protects you.
Él te protege.
Let me say that again, everybody.
Déjame repito otra vez.
When the Father loves you,
cuando el Padre te ama,
he protects you.
Él te protege.
And why would the Father love you?
¿Y por qué el Padre te va a amar?
If you're not doing what he asked you to do.
Si tú no haces lo que él te pidió que hagas.
So what we're seeing here,
estamos viendo
aquí, is all this leads up to him celebrating Hanukkah.
Todo esto nos lleva a cuando él está celebrando Hanukkah.
In its time of the feast of dedication, all the Jews understood this.
En el tiempo de la fiesta de dedicación, todos los judíos entendían esto.
It had happened less than 200 years before.
Pasado eso hace 200 años, no ha pasado eso.
Maybe 180 years before Yeshua was walking the earth as a man again.
Quizás hace 180 años antes que Yeshua entre caminando.
All the Jews were getting ready for Hanukkah.
Todos los judíos estaban alistándose para Hanukkah.
They understood.
Ellos entendían.
They understood what was going on.
Ellos entendían lo que estaba pasando.
So here Yeshua gives this whole teaching, this discourse.
Aquí vemos a Yeshua, su enseñanza, este discurso.
Laying his life down.
Entregando su vida.
The sheep, I'm a shepherd.
Yo soy el pastor.
You're going to see Mattathias Maccabee is a shepherd.
Vas a ver que Matadías es un pastor.
He's going to gather his people.
Él va a reunir a sus gente.
He's going to take his flock to the hills.
Va a llevar a su rebaño a las montañas.
He's going to fight against a much larger army.
Él va a pelear con un ejército más grande.
But because the father loves the Maccabees,
porque el padre amó a los Macabeos,
he's going to protect them.
Él los va a proteger.
Because they lay their life down to get back the temple of God.
Porque ellos entregaron su vida para traer y devolver el templo a Dios.
When everybody else is, you know, doing pagan stuff.
Cuando todo el mundo está haciendo cosas paganas.
They say, no, we're not doing this anymore.
Ellos dicen, no, no vamos a hacer esto.
We're not doing this anymore.
No vamos a hacer esto.
And that's why you see Yeshua celebrating in verse 22 and 23.
Es por eso que vamos a ver a Yeshua que está celebrando en el versículo 22 y 23.
I lay my life down.
Entregué mi vida.
I dedicate my life.
Yo dediqué mi vida.
So that I can pick it up again.
Así yo puedo recobrar otra vez.
Hanukkah is about dedication of your lives.
Hanukkah se trata acerca de la dedicación de tus vidas.
Dedication of our lives. Going on to the next slide.
Próxima página.
Turn to Luke 21, please.
Vamos a Lucas 21.
Luke 21, please.
Lucas 21.
Verse 16 through 19.
Versículo 16 al 19.
Luke 21.
Lucas 21.
Verse 16 through 19.
Versículo 16 al 19.
Luke 21, verse 16 through 19.
Lucas 21, versículo 16 al 19.
When you got it, say amen. Amen. You will be betrayed even by parents, brothers, relatives, and friends. Some of you they will have put to death, and everyone will hate you because of me. But not a hair of your head will be lost. By standing firm, you will save your lives. Amen. Now here, many of us betray the Lord.
Muchos engañarán, traicionarán al Señor.
Once again, this is all about dedicating our lives.
Una vez más, todo esto se trata acerca de dedicar nuestras vidas.
But a lot of people will betray us.
Pero muchas personas nos traicionarán.
Yeshua says, "I will split apart families."
Y Yeshua dice, yo dividiré familias.
3 against 2, 4 against 5.
3 en contra de 2 y 4 en contra de 5.
So you're going to be betrayed even to death.
Vas a ser traicionado incluso a muerte.
And this is also what happens in the book of Maccabees.
Y esto es lo que pasa en el libro de los Macabeos.
We're going to read an account.
Vamos a leer una cuenta.
Of a group of people that were betrayed.
De un grupo de personas que fueron traicionados.
But if you stand.
Traicionados.
Okay, but if you stand firm, look at verse 19, that is your key.
El versículo 19, es tu clave.
By standing firm, you will save your lives.
Por pararte okay. firme, tú salvarás tus vidas.
By standing firm on God's word,
por pararte duro en la palabra de Dios,
and fighting for the right causes.
Y pelear por la causa correcta.
See, a lot of times we like to battle all the time.
Muchas de las veces tú quieres pelear.
But you got to pick your fights.
Tú quieres batallar. Tú tienes que escoger tus batallas.
Is this fight going to glorify God?
¿Esta batalla va a glorificar a Dios?
By standing firm for Shabbat, is that going to glorify God?
Por estar firme para el Shabbat, ¿es esto va a glorificar a Dios?
By standing firm for the holy days, is that going to glorify God?
Por estar firme en los días santos, ¿esto va a glorificar
a
Dios?
By doing what Yeshua did, is that going to glorify God?
Al hacer lo que Yeshua hizo, ¿va a glorificar a Dios?
And the answer is amen, amen, amen.
Y la respuesta es amén.
Do I have an amen?
Amen.
Okay. By standing firm,
por estar firme,
you're going to save your lives.
Vas a salvar tu vida.
Going on to the next slide. Turn to Matthew 24.
Mateo 24.
Matthew 24.
Mateo 24.
Verse 15. Through 19.
Versículo 15 al 19.
20, sorry.
15 al 20.
15 through 20.
15 al 20.
If you want to highlight in your Bible these verses, this is all about Hanukkah.
Todos estos versos, si quieres subrayar en tus Biblias, son para Hanukkah.
I only got to two of the verses before. But 15 through 20 is all about Hanukkah.
Versículo 15 al 20 es todo acerca de Hanukkah.
And when you read the book of Maccabees, you're going to see exactly every verse here.
Y cuando leas el libro de los Macabeos, vas a ver exactamente estos versos.
So let's read Matthew 15 to 20.
Leamos Mateo 24, versículo 15 al 20.
So when you see the abomination that causes desolation spoken about through the prophet Daniel, standing in the holy place, let the reader understand the allusion. That will be the time for those in Yehuda to escape to the hills. If someone is on the roof, He must not go down to gather his belongings from his house. If someone is in the field, he must not turn back to get his coat. What a terrible time it will be for pregnant women and nursing mothers. Pray that you will not have to escape in winter or on Shabbat. Amen. Each one of those verses is from the book of Maccabees.
Cada uno de estos versos es del libro de los Macabeos.
And I will show you this when we read 1 Maccabees chapter 1 through chapter 4.
Y te voy a enseñar cuando leamos el libro de los Macabeos capítulo 1 hasta el capítulo 4.
Sí. In verse 15, let's look back at verse 15.
Miremos otra vez el versículo 15.
So when you see the abomination that causes desolation spoken about through the prophet Daniel standing in the holy place, let the reader understand the allusion. Amen?
No.
Now this had happened about 180 years before Messiah came to earth as a man again.
Esto pasó 180 años antes de que el Mesías venga acá al mundo.
In the year 163 BC.
En el año
163 BC, before Messiah.
163 antes del Mesías.
Okay. Antiochus Epiphanes.
Antíoco Epífano.
Puts an idol of himself.
Puso un ídolo de sí mismo.
Into the most holy place.
En el lugar más santo.
He thought he was Zeus.
Él pensó que era Zeus.
Okay, as a Roman emperor, he thought he was Zeus.
Él pensó que era Zeus como el emperador romano.
He makes the likeness of Zeus and puts it in the most holy place.
Él hizo la imagen de Zeus y puso en el lugar más santo.
So Yeshua is talking about this.
Yeshua está hablando de esto.
But it had already happened, so it's going to happen again.
Pero ya pasó y va a pasar nuevamente.
Okay, verse 16.
Versículo 16.
That will be the time for those in Yehuda to escape to the hills. Amen?
Amen.
When we get to 1 Maccabees,
cuando vayamos al primero de Macabeos,
we're going to see Mattathias.
Vamos a ver a Mattathias.
Kill the Roman centurion.
Matando al centurión romano.
And he says, run to the hills.
Y dice, corran a las montañas.
Everybody that is with me, run to the hills. Yeshua is quoting him.
Todo aquel que está conmigo, vayan a las montañas. Yeshua está citando esto.
Look at verse 17 now.
Mira el versículo 17.
If someone is on the roof, he must not go down to gather his belongings from his house. Look at 18.
Mira el 18.
If someone is in the field, he must not turn back to get his coat. Amen?
Amen.
Yeshua was reading Maccabees.
Yeshua estaba leyendo Macabeos.
Because I'm going to read this to you.
Voy a leerte a ti.
Because this is what Mattathias says.
Porque esto es lo que Mattathias dijo.
Leave everything behind.
Deja todo atrás.
We must go now. Run to the hills now.
Debemos irnos ahora, ir a las montañas.
Don't gather your belongings.
No recojas tus pertenencias.
Don't go back to the field. Just come with me.
No regreses al campo. Solo ven conmigo.
Because I just started a war.
Solo porque acabo de empezar la batalla.
I just started a war.
Acabo de empezar la guerra.
Now verse 19.
Ahora el versículo 19.
What a terrible time it would be for pregnant women and nursing mothers. Amen?
Amen.
That is another quote from the book of 1 Maccabees.
Esa es otra cita del libro de Macabeos.
Because what they were doing,
lo que estaban haciendo,
is taking the baby boys.
Estaban tomando los niños varones.
And we will read this.
Y leímos
esto. But I want you to see it in the gospel.
Pero quiero que veas en el evangelio.
So you can have no doubt in your mind.
Así no vas a tener duda en tu mente.
That Yeshua is absolutely celebrating the feast of dedication.
Que Yeshua está absolutamente celebrando la fiesta de dedicación.
Because once again in verse 19.
Porque una vez en el versículo 19.
What a terrible time it will be for pregnant women and nursing mothers. That is what happened in 1 Maccabees.
Eso es lo que pasó en el primer libro de Macabeos.
If you circumcised your child,
si circuncidas a tu hijo,
if you circumcise your boy at 8 days, which is a commandment of God,
si circuncidas al hijo varón a los 8 días, porque es un mandamiento,
they would kill the baby,
ellos matarían al bebé,
and hang it around the mother's throat,
y lo colgarían alrededor del cuello de la madre,
until it rotted off the body.
Hasta que se descomponga el cuerpo.
So that would be a pretty bad time for pregnant women, don't you think?
Eso sería bien malo para la mujer embarazada.
That would be a pretty bad time for nursing mothers, don't you think?
Eso sería bien malo para las mujeres que están dando a amamantar.
And why is he saying this?
¿Y por qué está diciendo
why
esto?
Why is he saying this?
¿Por qué está diciendo
because
esto?
It had just happened.
Porque acabó de pasar.
Less than 200 years before this, it had just happened.
Menos de 200 años acabó de pasar.
Now verse 20.
Ahora el versículo 20.
This is all taken from Maccabees, everybody.
Todo esto fue tomado de los Macabeos.
Pray that you will not have to escape in winter or on Shabbat. We will read.
leímos esto.
In 1 Maccabees.
En la primera Maccabees.
I believe it's in chapter 2.
Yo creo que está en el capítulo 2.
There was a group of Jews.
Había un grupo de judíos.
That they would not fight on the Sabbath.
Que no iban a pelear en el Sábado.
The Maccabees were different.
Los Maccabeos fueron diferentes.
They said we will not attack somebody on the Sabbath.
Dijeron no atacaremos a nadie en el Sábado.
But if we are attacked, we will fight.
Pero si nos atacan, pelearemos.
On the other hand,
en la otra mano,
there was a whole other group.
Había otro grupo.
That the Romans knew.
Que los romanos conocían.
The Romans knew.
Los romanos conocían.
That they would not fight on Shabbat.
Que no iban a pelear en Shabbat.
So here Yeshua is saying, pray that you don't have to escape on Shabbat.
Yeshua está diciendo, oren para que no pase en Shabbat.
Verse 15 through 20 is all about Hanukkah.
Versículo 15 al 20 es todo acerca de Hanukkah.
But why?
Digo, ¿por qué?
If our God is King of all creation,
si nuestro Dios es el Rey de toda
if
la
our
creación,
God is King of everything,
si nuestro Dios es el Rey de todo,
why would He let this abomination that causes desolation in His house?
¿Por qué él dejaría que toda esta abominación que cause desolación en su casa?
Why would He let Zeus in our house?
¿Por qué dejó que Zeus entre en nuestra casa?
Because He left.
Porque él los abandonó.
He left.
Él se fue.
Because we left Him.
Porque nosotros le dejamos,
That's
lo abandonamos.
Why we studied Revelation today.
Es por eso que estudiamos Revelaciones hoy día.
Seven seals.
Siete sellos.
Seven shofars.
Siete shofares.
But yet the people still don't want to hear the laws of God.
Pero la gente no quería escuchar las leyes de Dios.
So God says, all right, you don't want me?
El Señor dijo, está bien, no
you
me
don't
quieren.
Want me? You don't want my protection?
No quieres mi protección.
You don't want to worship me?
No quieres adorarme.
I'll let them put crap in my house.
Yo voy a dejar que pongan basura en mi casa.
Because it's just a building.
Pero es solo un edificio.
And your altar is so defiled, I don't want to smell your stuff.
Y tu altar está bien contaminado, yo no quiero oler eso.
You don't want to worship me?
No quieres adorarme a mí.
You want to worship all those animal gods?
¿Quieres adorar a todos esos dioses animales?
You want to worship sex?
¿Quieres adorar al sexo?
You want to worship bodies?
¿Quieres adorar cuerpos?
You want to worship money?
¿Quieres adorar el
Go
dinero?
Ahead. I'm going to leave my house.
Haz eso, yo voy a dejar mi casa.
But there is a group.
Pero hay un grupo.
Called the Maccabees.
Que se llama Maccabeos.
That stands up.
Que ellos se pusieron firmes.
Says, we're not going to take this garbage anymore.
Ellos dijeron, no vamos a aguantar más de esta basura.
But they first look inside themselves.
Pero primero ellos miraron dentro de sí mismo.
See, five of us will chase 100.
Cinco de nosotros perseguirán a 100.
And 100 of us will chase 10,000.
Y 100 de nosotros perseguirán a 10,000.
Now if we have 10,000.
Ahora somos 10,000.
We'll chase 100,000.
Perseguiríamos a 100,000.
We got 100,000.
Tenemos 100,000.
We're going to chase a million.
Vamos a perseguir a millones.
Because it's not by power.
Porque no es por poder.
It is not by might.
No es por mente.
It is by my spirit,
es
says
por mi espíritu,
the Lord.
Dice el Señor.
But we need a clean altar.
Porque necesitamos un altar limpio.
All this is happening, what Yeshua was talking about.
Todo esto está pasando de lo que Yeshua está
hablando. In Matthew 24, verse 15 through 20.
En Mateo 24, versículo 15 al 20.
Because God left His house.
Porque el Señor dejó la casa.
He didn't forget to lock the door because God doesn't forget.
Él no se olvidó de cerrar la puerta porque el Señor no se olvida.
He left it because you didn't want to worship Him.
Él se fue porque tú no querías adorarlo.
My family didn't want to worship Him.
No quiso adorarlo.
So now, ladies and gentlemen,
ahora, damas y caballeros,
we stand in the gap.
Estamos en ¿dónde? En la brecha.
We stand in the gap.
Estamos parados en la brecha.
Realize how important your role is.
Sabemos qué importante tu papel es.
How important your dedication is to God.
Qué importante es tu dedicación a Dios.
Mothers, imagine a pregnant mother.
Imagínese una las mujeres embarazadas.
Heidi, imagine.
Imagínate.
Imagine. Imagine.
Imagínate.
That you were going to have to hide your baby.
Que vas a tener que esconder a tu bebé.
David. Imagine. In a couple of months.
Imagínate, un par de meses.
You can't hide that she's pregnant.
No puedes esconder que ella está embarazada.
Everybody sees Heidi. Here's Heidi.
Todos ven a Heidi.
That's okay, there's a baby in there.
Está bien, hay
it
un
wasn't
bebé
the
dentro.
Pizza I ate, but it was good.
No es la pizza que comió,
everybody sees that she's pregnant.
Todos lo ven. Está embarazada.
Is Ivana free? Heidi, come here. Ivana, come here a second.
Ivana, ven acá.
Come here. Turn around. No, don't hide that. I want to show the baby. Come here, pregnant one. Come here. Hey, we all got here because ladies carried babies.
Todos estamos aquí porque las mujeres.
Come on over here.
Llevan bebés.
Just like before. Imagine.
Imagínate.
The Romans are watching.
Los romanos están observando.
They see she's Jewish.
Ellos ven que ella es judía.
They see she's Jewish.
Ellos ven que ella es judía.
They're writing it down just like the Cubans write it down.
Ellos están tomando notas, así
they're looking and seeing baby.
Están observando que hay un
baby.
Bebé.
They're going to come around.
Ellos van a venir.
Imagine having to worry, ladies.
Imagínate tener que estar preocupada.
You didn't know if it was a boy or a girl.
Tú no sabes si era un varón o mujer.
You didn't know if it was a boy or a girl.
Tú no sabes si era varón o mujer.
But you're Jewish women.
Pero tú eres una mujer
judía. What if you have baby boys, what do we do on the eighth day?
¿Qué sería si tuvieras bebés varones? ¿Qué serás en el octavo día?
But imagine.
Pero imagínate.
That you would have to be worried for this and this.
Imagínate que tendrás que estar preocupado por él y por él.
I want you to see how important Hanukkah is.
Yo quiero que veas cuán importante es esto.
We don't have to worry right now.
No tenemos que preocuparnos en estos momentos.
But if we don't keep doing our job,
pero si no hacemos nuestro trabajo,
you better believe we're going to have to worry.
Es mejor que creas que vamos a tener que preocuparnos.
And it's all because God leaves His house.
Y es todo porque el Señor deja esta casa.
God will protect us.
El Señor nos protegerá.
If we follow His commandments.
Si seguimos sus mandamientos.
Yeshua is talking about a time.
Yeshua está hablando de un tiempo.
In the future.
En el futuro.
And once that third temple goes up, people.
Una vez que el tercer templo se levante.
Know that in 3.5 years, this is going to happen again.
Sabiendo que en 3 años y medio esto va a volver a pasar.
So one thing we like, yeah, we want the temple up, right?
Una vez que la gente dice que el templo se levante.
But in another thing, we don't want the temple up.
Pero en otro lado no queremos que el templo se levante.
It's a very because the prophecies don't lie.
Porque las profecías no mienten.
Going on to the next slide.
Próxima página.
Hanukkah.
Hanukkah.
What is its significance?
¿Cuál es su significado?
It is the rededication of the temple after it was defiled.
Es la rededicación del templo después que ha sido contaminado.
It is the rededication of the temple after it was defiled.
Es la rededicación del templo después que ha sido contaminado.
The length, if there is a temple, is 8 days.
Son 8 días del templo.
7 of a consecration.
7 de consagración.
1 for a holy convocation.
Y una para una convocación
it
santa.
Follows the pattern.
Sigue el patrón.
That is set forth in Exodus.
Que ha sido del Éxodo.
When we instill the priesthood, it's a 7-day consecration,
cuando
right?
Cuando aún estaba el sacerdocio, había 7 días de consagración.
Aaron and his sons could not leave the temple for 7 days.
Aarón y sus hijos no podían dejar el templo por 7 días.
In the consecration that Shlomo did in 2 Chronicles 7.
La consagración que Salomón hizo en Crónicas 7.
He had a festival for 7 days.
Tuvo un festival de 7 días.
And on the 8th day, it was a holy convocation for everybody.
Y en el octavo día era una convocación santa para todos.
8 is the number of a new beginning.
8 es el número para un nuevo comienzo.
That's why it's a 7-day for the temple.
Es por eso que es el 7 días para el templo.
An 8th day for a holy convocation for all people.
Y el octavo día para una convocación para toda la gente.
The prophetic nature of Hanukkah.
La naturaleza profética de Hanukkah.
Is all about the end of days.
Se trata acerca del fin de los días.
Once you see that third temple.
Una vez que veas el tercer templo.
Read your prophecies, everybody.
Lee las profecías.
Read Isaiah.
Lee
Isaías. Read every prophet.
Lee todo profeta.
And you're going to see what God says about the end of days.
Y vas a ver lo que Dios dice acerca del fin de los tiempos.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Now a lot of people in Judaism think it's about oil.
En el judaísmo piensan que se trata acerca del aceite.
Dr. Mark asked me a great question.
Dr. Mark me hizo una pregunta.
Earlier, I was like, where does the story of the oil come from?
¿De dónde viene esto del aceite?
I gave him a straight honest answer. I have no idea.
Yo le di una respuesta directa. No tengo
long
idea.
Time ago I asked my own rabbi.
Yo mucho tiempo atrás le pregunté a mi rabino.
Rabbi Fish.
Rabino Fish.
Yes, Mr. Dinnerman, what do you want?
Sí, señor Dinnerman, ¿qué necesita?
Why are you talking to me again?
¿Por qué está hablando conmigo otra vez?
I got a question.
Tengo una pregunta.
You always have questions.
Siempre tienes preguntas.
You're getting annoying.
Estás siendo molestoso.
But Rabbi Fish.
Pero Rabino Fish.
Really nice guy.
He took my.
he was so nice when I was not.
Él era bien buena persona cuando yo no lo era.
I asked him, where did the oil come from?
¿De dónde viene este aceite?
Well, it says somewhere that it lasted 8 days.
Dice en algún lado que ha durado por 8 días.
Can you tell me where it says it?
¿Me puedes decir en dónde lo encuentro? ¿Dónde
Mr.
dice?
Mr. Dinnerman, why don't you go to the bathroom or something?
Señor Dinnerman, ¿por qué no se va al baño?
You're
o algo?
Giving me such a headache.
Me está dando un dolor de cabeza.
Where does the oil story come from? I have no idea.
¿De dónde está empezó a venir el aceite? No tengo no idea.
Like, you know, come on, it's got to be somewhere.
Debe haber en algún lado.
Okay, so is it oil or something else for Hanukkah?
¿Es el aceite o algo más para
Going
Hanukkah?
On to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
We're going to find out that Hanukkah is all about the altar.
Vamos a encontrar que Hanukkah se trata acerca del altar.
Earlier this morning in the Shabbat message 616.
Temprano en el mensaje de Shabbat en el 616.
If you want to turn with me to Genesis 8, please.
Vamos a Génesis 8.
Versículo
20 al 21.
Genesis 8, verse 20 and 21.
Génesis 8, versículo 20 al 21.
Noah built an altar to Jehovah, and he took from every clean animal and every clean bird, and he offered burnt offerings on the altar. Jehovah smelled the sweet aroma. Noah said in his heart, I will never again curse the ground because of man, since the imaginings of his heart are evil from his youth, nor will I ever again destroy all living things as I have done. Amen? We went over this at length this morning.
Vimos este pasaje en la mañana.
What's the first thing Noah does?
¿Qué es lo primero que Noah hizo?
He doesn't like run outside the ark and go, just run for a day.
Él no salió solo del arca y
Remember, he's stuck in that stinky ark for a year.
Estuvo él estancado en esa arca por un año.
You know, what would you do? You know, you're stuck in a place for a year.
¿Qué hicieras tú si estás en un lugar atrapado por un año?
What would be the first thing that you would do?
¿Qué es lo primero que tú harías?
I'd like, I'm running.
Soy libre, soy okay? Libre de correr.
But what does the first thing that Noah does?
¿Qué es lo primero que Noé hace?
He builds an altar.
Él construye un altar.
He builds an altar to the Father.
Él construye un altar para el Padre.
And the Lord says, boy, I miss that smell.
Y el Señor dice, extrañaba ese olor.
This is why you know God is a man.
Es por eso que sabemos que el Señor es un hombre.
Because you see, men, anybody time somebody lights up a barbecue, what happens?
Vemos cuando un hombre está pasando cuando alguien hace
what
una
happens?
Barbacoa. ¿Qué,
what
¿qué
happens
pasa?
If somebody lights up a barbecue?
¿Qué pasa cuando alguien está haciendo un asado?
You know, I'm over here lighting up my barbecue, right? I'm all alone, right?
Estoy solo ahí.
I'm getting the barbecue.
Estoy haciendo la
all
barbacoa.
Of a sudden, you see one man come.
Y de la nada ves
another
que
guy come.
Un hombre se acerca.
It's like, you know, it's like, you know, it's like, what are you guys doing here?
Y dice, ¿qué
we smelled the barbecue,
aquí?
We smelled you.
Apercibimos la barbacoa.
So God was, you know, look at verse 21.
Mira el versículo 21.
He smelled it and is like, phew, I love that sweet aroma.
Él está respirando ese aroma.
Nothing better than some good beef on the grill.
Una buena carne en la parrilla.
So after the destruction,
en la destrucción,
after the destruction of the world,
después de la destrucción del mundo,
the first thing Noah does,
lo primero que Noé hizo,
builds an altar to Jehovah.
Construyó un altar hacia Jehová.
So this is a very important structure.
Esta es una instrucción importante.
But it had to be with a heart.
Esta es una estructura importante, pero debe ser con el corazón.
It has to be with a heart of wanting to please the Father.
Debe ser con el corazón de querer complacerle al Padre.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la siguiente página.
If we look at, turn to Genesis 12, please, Bereshit 12.
Vamos a Génesis 12.
In verse 7 is our key.
El versículo 7 es nuestra clave.
Bereshit 12 is the promise chapter.
Génesis 12 es un capítulo de promesas.
It's all about the sevenfold promise.
Se trata acerca de las siete bendiciones.
Our key verse is number 7.
Nuestra clave es el versículo 7.
Jehovah appeared to Abram, said to your descendants, I will give you this land. So he built an altar there to Jehovah, what appeared to him. Amen? So here, the second part of an altar,
aquí la segunda parte del altar,
is an altar of inheritance.
Es un altar de herencia.
An altar of inheritance.
Un altar de herencia.
Because God said, I'm going to give you the sevenfold blessing that we talked about this morning.
Porque el Señor dice que te voy a dar las siete bendiciones que hablamos de esta mañana.
Now Abraham,
ahora Abraham
builds this altar to the Lord.
Él construye este altar hacia al Señor.
He dedicates this thing to the Lord.
Él dedica esto al Señor.
Hanukkah is about dedication of an altar to God.
Hanukkah se trata acerca de la dedicación del altar a Dios.
But if you don't have a clean heart,
pero si no tienes un corazón limpio.
Now we go back to 1 Corinthians 3 that we started out with, right?
Regresamos a 1 de Corintios 3.
You're the temple.
Tú eres el templo.
But you're putting garbage on your altar.
Pondrías tu basura en tu altar.
You're drinking hard alcohol.
Estás tomando bebidas alcohólicas.
You're smoking cigarettes.
Fumando cigarrillos.
You're destroying your temple.
Estás destruyendo tu templo.
You're eating unclean foods. You're destroying your temple.
Estás comiendo comida impura. Estás destruyendo tu templo.
You're gossiping. You're destroying your temple.
Estás chismoseando. Estás destruyendo
so
tu templo.
So here Noah knew that he was blessed.
Aquí vemos que Noé fue bendecido.
He gets out of the ark. The first thing he does.
Salió del arca y lo primero que hizo.
Builds an altar to God.
Construyó un altar a
Dios. I want you to understand because we're going to read Maccabees.
Quiero que entiendas porque vamos a leer
We're going to see that the whole temple is defiled.
Vamos a ver que todo el templo fue contaminado.
But nothing happens until the altar is replaced.
Pero no, nada pasa hasta que el altar es reemplazado.
Hanukkah has everything to do with an altar to God.
Hanukkah tiene todo que ver con un altar hacia Dios.
Next slide. Próximo. Turn to Genesis 22.
Génesis 22.
Genesis 22.
Génesis 22.
We're going to look at verse 9.
Vamos a mirar el versículo 9.
Genesis Bereshit 22.
Genesis 22.
Verse 9.
Versículo 9.
They came to the place Elohim had told him about, and Abraham built an altar there. Set the wood in order, bound Yitzhak his son, laid him on the altar on the wood. Amen. Okay, so he goes up a mountain.
Va a la montaña, arriba a la montaña.
So you can be sure that this is an altar of stone.
Para asegurarse que este es un altar de piedra.
Okay, he builds an altar of stone.
Construye un altar de piedra.
If you read all this, you see he goes up a mountain.
Si lees todo esto, vemos que él va arriba a la montaña.
This is not going to be a mound of dirt.
No va a ser una montaña de tierra.
So, okay, he offers up his son.
Porque él le va a ofrecer a su
the
hijo.
The son of the promise gets offered on an altar.
El hijo de la promesa que es ofrecido en un altar.
And it was a test for Abraham that we learned earlier today.
Y era una prueba para Abraham, Abraham que lo que aprendimos en la mañana.
Because Abraham was now walking in God's footsteps.
Porque ahora Abraham estaba caminando en los pasos de Dios.
Going on to the next slide.
Próxima.
Turn to Exodus 29, verse 36 and 37.
Vamos a Éxodo 29, versículo 36 al 37.
Okay, it's up on the screen there. Or have you been switching the slides? We only have Maccabees on. Do you have the full PowerPoint up there? No, but it's in Spanish over here.
Not this thing. No,
it's just Maccabees?
Just Maccabees.
Just Maccabees. Okay. Yes. I'm sorry. I thought, okay. Exodus, Shemot 29, verse 36 and 37.
Exodus 29, versículo 36
in the 37. In the picture there you see
en la fotografía tú ves
the Mishkan.
El Mishkan.
Okay, and the Mishkan is the tabernacle in the desert.
El Mishkan es el tabernáculo en el desierto.
Starting from the right, let me get my mouse so you can see it.
Empezando por la derecha.
Oh, go back. Okay, let me just. Okay, this is where you enter into the tabernacle.
Aquí es cuando entras al tabernáculo.
It is a 30-foot screen.
Hay una
curtain, 30
una
foot
cortina
curtain.
De 30 pies.
Okay, the very first thing that you come to
lo primero que tú vas a pasar
is the altar.
Es el altar
for the burnt offerings.
Para la ofrenda quemada.
Okay, what
para
you see right there is the altar for the burnt offerings.
Lo que ves ahí es el altar para las ofrendas.
Then you have the wash basin.
Your mouse is not visible.
My mouse is not visible?
No.
Well, stop that. Is it visible now?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So here you see the altar.
Ahí ves el altar.
Okay, that's the very first thing that you see after you enter into the curtain.
Es lo primero que vas a ver cuando pases la cortina.
So the very first thing that you see is going to be the most holy thing.
Lo primero que vas a ver es lo más santo.
Okay, it's what makes the rest of the place holy.
Es lo que hace al resto del lugar santo.
Okay, and I'll tell you why in a minute.
Y te digo el porqué en un minuto.
Then the next part is the wash basin.
Y pues la otra parte es lavamanos.
Okay, then here is the holy place.
Y después
Jiminy Crickets.
Después aquí está el lugar santo.
Okay, there, that's the holy place.
Ese es el lugar santo.
And in, you enter into the holy place.
Entras al lugar santo.
On the left side is the menorah.
En la izquierda está la menorah.
On the right side is the bread of the presence.
Está el pan de la presencia.
And then in front of you is the incense offering table.
Y enfrente de ti es la mesa de incienso.
And then you go past that is another 15-foot curtain.
Y cuando pases hay otra cortina de 15 pies.
And that is the most holy place.
Y ese es el lugar santísimo.
But you don't get there until you go to the altar.
Tú no llegas allá si no vas al altar.
Let's read verse 36 and 37.
Leamos el versículo 36 y 37.
Each day offer a young bull as a sin offering besides the other offerings of the atonement. Offer the sin offering on the altar as your atonement for it. Then anoint and consecrate it. Verse 37. 7 days you are to make atonement on the altar and consecrate it. Thus the altar will be especially holy, and whatever touches the altar will become holy. Amen? Look at verse 37, it's very important.
Mira, el versículo 37 es muy importante.
7 days you will make atonement on the altar and consecrate it. Thus the altar will be especially holy, and whoever touches the altar will become holy. Whatever touches.
Lo que sea que tope.
So if you're the temple of God,
si tú eres el templo de Dios,
where's the most holy part in your body?
¿Dónde está la parte más santa en tu cuerpo?
Your heart, your altar.
En tu corazón, tu altar.
And Hanukkah is all about the altar.
Y Hanukkah es todo acerca del altar.
Whatever touches the altar,
lo que tope el altar,
that becomes holy.
Eso se convierte en santo.
That becomes mashach.
Eso se convierte en mashach.
Mashach is the anointing, the liquid consecration.
Es el ungido, el consagrado.
They're going to consecrate everything with this special oil.
Va a ser consagrado con aceite especial.
That, by the way, is made.
Y eso es hecho.
The oil for the temple has been made.
El aceite del templo ya ha sido hecho.
It is only for the temple. So somebody says, I got the temple oil, don't touch it.
Es solamente para el templo. Si alguien dice, yo tengo el templo
don't
del aceite,
even be with that person.
Ni siquiera te acerques a esa
because
persona.
You will die.
Porque tú morirías.
You might not die here in the physical, but you have died in the spirit.
Quizás no mueras en lo físico, pero vas a morir
it
en lo espiritual.
Only
es solamente
for the temple.
Solo para el templo.
It's a very special consecration mixture of the oil.
Es una mezcla especial consagrada para el templo.
So we see here the altar is especially holy.
Vemos aquí que el altar es algo santo.
And whatever touches the altar,
y todo lo que tope el altar,
will become holy.
Se convertirá en santo.
Going on to the next slide.
Próxima.
Turn to 2 Chronicles 7, please.
Vamos a 2 Crónicas 7.
2 Chronicles 7, verse 9.
2 Crónicas 7, versículo
9. 2 Chronicles 7, verse 9.
Segundo libro de Crónicas, capítulo 7, versículo 9.
2 Chronicles 7, verse 9. On the eighth day, they held a solemn assembly, having observed the dedication of the altar 7 days and the festival 7 days. Amen? We just read it.
Acabamos de leer.
We just read in Exodus, right?
Acabamos de leer en el Éxodo.
So what is this eighth day?
¿Qué es este octavo día?
It's a consecration of the people.
Es la consagración de la gente.
Eight is the number of a new beginning.
Ocho es el número del nuevo comienzo.
And you see there, it is the word Chanukah.
Y ves ahí es la palabra Chanukah.
Dedication, the word Chanukah or Hanach.
Dedication, la palabra Chanukah o Hanach.
It means covenant, consecration.
Significa consagrar y un pacto.
Dedication.
Dedicación.
They're dedicating this particular thing.
Están dedicando esta cosa en particular.
For one purpose.
Por un propósito.
And one purpose alone.
Y para solo un propósito.
So the same goes for your heart.
Lo mismo va para tu corazón.
That's why Yeshua is in the temple inspecting.
Es por eso que Yeshua está en el templo inspeccionando.
Is everything okay? Is everything okay?
Todo está bien.
Is everything okay? He's looking around. He's wandering around. He's like,
está mirando alrededor.
You know, just imagine Yeshua.
Solo me imagino a Yeshua.
Ow. Ow. He's walking around.
Él está caminando.
Is everything okay?
Todo mm-hmm. está bien.
Is it okay for my dedication?
Está bien para mi dedicación.
Altar looks good.
El altar se mira bien.
Wash basin's good.
El lavadero está bien.
Can't see into the holy place.
No puedo ver el lugar santo.
Because it has a veil.
Porque tiene el velo.
But he can see the altar.
Pero puedes ver el altar.
He can see the wash basin.
Puedes ver el lavado de el
lavadero. So that's why he was wandering around the temple to see if everything was okay.
Es por eso que él estaba alrededor del templo para ver que todo está bien.
But the eighth day is a dedication. That's the solemn assembly is only one day.
Pero el octavo día es una convocación santa.
That's
un día.
That's why we're only doing one day.
Es por eso que se hace un solo día.
The other seven are for the temple.
Los otros siete son para el templo.
Does everybody understand that?
Entienden todos esto.
The reason we're only doing one day. Got that in Bogotá? También.
Lo tienen esto en Bogotá.
También. Okay, because we were talking about it. It was an excellent question.
Había unas preguntas excelentes.
It's a very excellent question.
Unas preguntas excelentes.
7 days is the consecration of everything.
7 días es la consagración de todo.
It's the eighth day, a single day.
Es el octavo día, un día singular.
A solemn assembly.
Una llamaron una asamblea.
Meaning everybody now.
Significa todos.
Not just the Kohanim.
No solo los Kohanim.
Everybody see that?
Están viendo todos esto.
So that's why we're doing the one day.
Es por eso que estamos haciendo solo un
we're
día.
Having our one solemn assembly.
Tenemos una asamblea solemne.
And if it's good enough for Solomon.
Y si era bueno
if it's
para
good enough
Solomon,
for King David.
Y si era bueno para el Rey David.
You know what? I'm going to follow them.
Y sabes que voy a seguir.
And Yeshua
los,
did it too. So I really follow hizo. Him.
Yeshua lo hizo, también lo voy a seguir a él.
Okay, it's a solemn assembly to remember what's most important in your temple.
Es una asamblea solemne para ver lo que es más importante en tu templo.
Remember, Rav Shaul is a rabbi. He's a trained rabbi.
Recuerda que el rabino Shaul es un rabino.
Okay, and he says in 1 Corinthians 3, what did we read? What did we start out with, everybody?
Dice, 1 Corinthians 3,
¿qué, stay with me.
Empezó?
Got another hour and a half. What did he say?
¿Qué es lo que dijo?
Your the temple of God.
Tú eres el templo de Dios.
And if you destroy the temple of God,
y si tú destruyes el templo de Dios,
Dad's going to be happy with you.
El Señor va a estar contento.
No,
contigo.
He's not going to be happy with
no
you.
Va a estar contigo.
He's going to destroy you.
Él va a destruirte.
So here in verse 9 again, let's read verse 9.
Aquí en el versículo 9, leamos otra vez.
On the eighth day, they held a solemn assembly, having observed the dedication of the altar 7 days and the festival 7 days. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, key word is assembly.
La palabra clave.
That means
asamblea.
It includes everybody.
Eso significa que incluye a todos.
Before that, it was just the workers in the temple.
Antes de eso, era solo los trabajadores del templo.
Okay, let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la siguiente página.
What else happens on the eighth day?
¿Qué más pasa en el octavo
turn
día?
Turn the book of Ayakwa, Leviticus 12, verse 3.
Vamos al libro de Levíticos. Capítulo 12, versículo
Leviticus
3.
12, verse 3.
Levíticos 12, versículo 3.
We're going to take a look at what happens on the eighth day, why it's important.
Vamos a mirar lo que pasa en el versículo 3. Y por
Leviticus
qué es importante. ¿Qué es lo
12,
que pasa?
Verse 3.
Levíticos 12, versículo 3.
On the eighth day, the baby's foreskin is to be circumcised. Amen?
Amen.
On the eighth day, the baby's foreskin is to be circumcised. Amen?
En el octavo día, so debe tener que ser circuncidado.
It's a consecration day.
Es una consagración,
for
un día
that
de consagración
family,
para esa familia.
They're bringing their child into the covenant with God.
Que traen al muchacho a un pacto con Dios.
And if it was good enough for Miriam and Joseph,
si era lo suficiente bueno para Miriam y
Yeshua's
Joseph,
parents,
los padres de Yeshua,
it's good enough for me.
Es bueno para mí también.
Okay, the eighth day,
el octavo día,
is a day of covenants.
Es un día de pacto.
Let me say that again.
Déjame repito otra
the
vez.
The eighth day,
el octavo día,
is a day of a Brit, a covenant.
Es un día de Brit, de un pacto.
Okay. Brit is the word in Hebrew for covenant.
Brit es la palabra en hebreo para pacto.
Hadasha means the new.
Hadashah significa el nuevo.
So it's actually covenant the new. Brit Hadashah is covenant the new.
Es un pacto nuevo, un Brit Hadashah.
Brit covenant.
Brit pacto.
Hadashah the new.
Hadashah el nuevo.
Okay, so covenant the new. On the eighth day, you're making a covenant with God with your male children.
En el octavo día, haces un pacto con Dios con tu hijo varón.
On the eighth day, the 25th of Kislev.
En el octavo día, eighth day.
That would be the day of the covenant.
Ese sería el día del pacto.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Turn to Matthew 23.
Vamos a Mateo 23.
Matthew 23.
Mateo 23.
Verse 18, verse 17 through 22.
Versículo 17 al 22.
Matthew 23.
Mateo 23.
Verse 17 through 22.
Versículo 17 al 22.
Anybody learning anything so far?
¿Están aprendiendo algo?
Martin, did they teach you this at the other place? Jiminy crickets. 13 years, they didn't teach you this? Well, maybe verse 17 is for them. You blind fools! Which is more important, the gold or the temple which makes the gold holy? And you say if someone swears by the altar, he's not bound by his oath. But if he swears by the offering on the altar, he is bound. Blind men, which is more important, the sacrifice or the altar which makes the sacrifice holy? So someone who swears by the altar swears by it and everything on it. And someone who swears by the temple swears by it, and the one who lives in it. Someone who swears by the heaven swears by God's throne, and the one who sits on it. Amen?
Amen.
Look at verse 19.
Mira el versículo 19.
Which is more important, the sacrifice or the altar which makes the sacrifice holy? The altar.
El altar.
What is most important? The altar.
¿Qué es más importante? El
altar. It's not the animal you're bringing.
No es el animal que tú estás trayendo.
It's the altar.
Es el altar.
Here Yeshua is saying the altar is the most important part.
Aquí vemos que Yeshua está diciendo que el altar es la parte más importante.
Hanukkah is, we're going to read.
Vamos a Hanukkah es. Si es
in Maccabees,
en Macabeos,
it's all about rededication of God's altar.
Es de la, se va a hablar de la rededicación del altar de Dios.
So once again in chapter 23.
Una vez más en el capítulo 23.
Which precedes chapter 24.
Lo que precede al capítulo 24.
23 becomes is before 24, right?
El 23 viene antes del 24.
Am I correct? 23 is antes, before. Ante 24? También?
Está bien.
Okay. Just want to make sure. Because maybe in Spanish you do them backwards or something.
Porque quizás en español haces al revés.
Capítulo 23, ante 24.
Capítulo 23, antes
¿también?
Del 24.
Okay. No? I didn't say it right. I thought I got it right. Chapter 23. Now, what happens in chapter 24?
¿Qué pasa en el capítulo 24?
And what did we read in verse 15 through 20?
¿Qué leímos en el versículo 15 al 20?
All about Hanukkah.
Todo acerca de Hanukkah.
Now, if you step back one chapter,
si te retrocedes un capítulo,
Yeshua is talking about the altar once again.
Yeshua está hablando acerca del altar una vez más.
So you can, without any doubt in your mind,
sin duda en tu mente,
understand that Yeshua is celebrating Hanukkah.
Vas a entender que Yeshua está celebrando Hanukkah.
In chapter 10 of John.
En el capítulo 10 de Juan.
Let's go on to now the time periods.
Vamos ahora al periodo de tiempo.
I'm going to quickly go through some of these time periods.
Vamos a ir por este periodo de tiempo.
It helps you to understand.
Te ayuda a entender.
What happened.
¿Qué es lo que pasó?
To the Israelites.
Con los israelíes.
What happens is they become a Hellenistic society.
¿Qué pasa cuando se convirtió en una sociedad helenística?
From the time of the end of the book of Malachi,
desde el final del libro de Malaquías,
to the book of Matthew,
al libro de Mateo,
is a 400 year period.
Es un periodo de 400 años.
Israel will be under 6 different types of governments.
Israel estuvo bajo 6 tipos de gobiernos.
Which is very prophetic.
Lo que es bien profético.
Why is that so prophetic?
¿Por qué es bien profético?
When Israel became a modern nation in 1948.
Cuando Israel se convirtió en una nación moderna en 1948.
How many nations came against Israel?
¿Cuántas naciones se pusieron en contra de Israel?
6 nations.
6 naciones.
6 nations. Okay? So here we have at the end of Malachi ends in the year 397 before Yeshua.
Aquí vemos que el tiempo de Malaquías termina en el año 397 antes que Yeshua.
This 400-year period is called the dark period or the dead period.
Estos 400 años se llama el período muerto.
Okay, it is also sometimes referred to as the intertestament period.
O también se
inter, like in the space in between.
So también se le conoce como ese tiempo entre estos dos, entre Malaquías, intermedios.
Intermedio.
Okay.
That's what I'm being told up here. Intermedio.
Intermedio.
Okay. Is Rabbi doing a good job? Because I didn't give many notes to this. Amen?
Amen?
Amen? He's doing a good job. Those who speak Spanish. I speak a little Spanish. Okay? So understand that for your notes.
Entiende para tus notas.
So if you're trying to talk to somebody, you need to speak to them about how it works.
Cuando tratas de hablar con alguien, necesitas hablar de algo como
tomar notas. And that's why when we started with Revelation this morning.
Así como empezamos con Apocalipsis esta mañana.
How does it get that bad?
¿Cómo esto se convierte así de malo?
That's why I did the news this morning.
Es por eso que hice las noticias.
The millennials are leaving congregation and church in droves.
Los en el milenio viven en las congregaciones.
We're in a dead period of.
Se están apartando.
Okay, we're in a dead period of spiritual right now.
Están apartando de las iglesias.
We're in a very dead period of
Estamos
spiritual
en verdad
people.
En un periodo muerto.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
The conditions of the Jews gets worse and worse spiritually each year.
La condición de los judíos se hace aún más peor cada año.
The Jews were carried into the Babylonian exile.
Los judíos que fueron llevados al exilio de Babilonia.
Between 606 and 586 before Yeshua.
Entre el año 606 y el 506 antes de Yeshua.
And this is why, you know, it starts a downward spiral of spirituality in Israel.
Es aquí donde empieza la falta de fidelidad en Jerusalén.
Okay. This and they were in Babylon for how many years?
Eso es lo que pasamos en Babilonia por cuántos 70 años?
70 years.
70 años.
Okay, Babylon, the Babylonian Empire.
Aquí en el Imperio Babilónico.
Is succeeded by the Medo-Persian Empire.
Sucede por el periodo Medo-Persia. Persia.
That's why it's so important.
Es por eso que es bien
when
importante.
You listen to the news,
cuando escuchas las noticias,
and you hear about the Kurds,
y escuchas acerca de los kurdos,
they're part of the Medo-Persian Empire.
Son partes del periodo Medo-Persia.
Okay, the Persian Emperor Cyrus.
El Imperio Persia es por medio de Cyrus.
He was friendly to the Jews.
Él fue el emperador de Persia que él perseguía.
No, he was friendly to the Jews.
Él fue amigo con los judíos.
Cyrus was Esther's king.
Okay. Sirio fue el rey de Esther.
He lets them return to Jerusalem small amounts of people.
Él dejó que regresen a Jerusalén en un pequeño monto de gente.
Going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Okay, we talked about this a little bit at the close of the book of Malachi.
Estamos acercándonos al libro de Malaquías.
The Jews are once again in Babylonian captivity.
Los judíos están una vez más en el cautiverio de Babilonia.
But now they're under the Persian Medo-Persian Empire.
Ahora están bajo el la esclavitud de Persia del Medio Persia Imperio Medio Persia.
Now the next part is very important.
Ahora esta parte es importante.
The royal line of David has fallen on evil days.
La línea real de David ha caído en sus días malvados.
The rightful successor of David, the person to follow David,
la persona que sigue a David,
was in the book of Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi.
Estaba en el libro de Haggai, Zacarías y Malaquías.
Okay, it then goes after Shlomo.
Y después se va a Salomón.
To Zerubbabel.
A Zerubbabel.
Okay. The royal prince, yet there was no king on the throne of Israel.
Un rey real que no era king, no era rey en el trono de Israel.
During the Persian Empire, there was no king in Israel.
Durante el periodo Persia, no había rey en Israel.
Now, when we go into the New Testament in Matthew,
ahora cuando nos vamos al Nuevo Testamento en el libro de
Mateo, this is where we get the very bad guy on the throne.
Es aquí cuando vemos a esta persona mala en el trono.
He was not the rightful king of Israel.
No era un rey de Israel.
He was put there by the government of Rome.
Él fue puesto ahí por el gobierno de Roma.
Going on to the next line.
Vamos a la próxima página.
When Yeshua comes in the book of Matthew,
cuando Yeshua viene en el libro de
the
Mateo,
Romans are now the power on the earth.
Los romanos ahora tienen el poder en el mundo.
Rome has spread throughout all of the civilized world.
Roma se espergió por todo el mundo.
But here in Israel,
pero aquí en Israel,
Herod is a descendant of Esau.
Herodes es un descendiente de Esau.
Let me say that again. Herod is not the line of David.
Herodes no es de la línea de David.
He's a descendant of Esau instead of Jacob.
Es un descendiente de Esau en vez de Jacob.
But this is why Yeshua is calling us back to Torah.
Es por eso que Yeshua nos está llamando de vuelta a la Torah.
Because what does Second Chronicles say?
Porque es lo que dice la segunda de
Crónicas. If my people,
si mi gente,
who are called by my name,
llaman mi nombre,
would humble themselves,
se humillan,
and turn from their wicked ways,
y regresan de sus caminos malvados,
I would hear from heaven,
escucharé,
and heal their land,
y sanaré la tierra.
But between those that 400 year period,
pero entre ese periodo, esos 400
Israel
años de
doesn't
periodo,
get better.
Israel no se mejora.
Israel gets spiritually sicker.
Israel se enferma más espiritualmente.
Because they become a Hellenistic society.
Porque se convirtió en una sociedad helenística.
What is a Hellenistic society?
¿Qué es esta sociedad helenística?
Everything's okay.
Todo está bien.
Do whatever you want. If you don't want to circumcise, don't circumcise.
Todo
we're
está
under
bien.
Grace.
Haz lo que tú quieras. Estamos por la gracia.
I don't say that flippantly tonight. I say that with fear.
Yo no digo eso así a la ligera. Digo eso con temor.
Because the Christians have become a Hellenistic society.
Porque los cristianos se han convertido en una sociedad helenística.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la siguiente página.
Here's how it breaks down in the six periods.
Aquí vemos cómo pasó en los seis tiempos de gobierno.
We get conquered by the Persians.
Fuimos conquistados por los
the Greeks.
Los Grecia.
The
Griegos.
Griegos. Griegos. Griegos. Right, Isabel? Oh, you're not here. The Persians, the Greeks.
Griegos. Griegos.
Yeah. Bagels? What?
Griegos.
Oh. Egyptians.
Los egipcios.
The Syrians.
Los sirios.
The Maccabees.
Los macabeos.
Then the Romans.
Y los romanos.
Why do you think Israel is so worried about Syria?
¿Por qué crees que Israel estaba muy preocupado de Siria?
Because they were conquered by them once before and it wasn't good.
Porque fueron conquistados por ellos una vez y no era tan bueno.
Why do you think Aleppo is so important, everybody?
¿Por qué crees que Aleppo es muy importante?
Because if you study history, you understand why.
Porque si estudias la historia vas a entender el por qué.
And that's why Hanukkah is so important to understand.
Y es por eso que Hanukkah es muy importante de entender.
None of this would happen.
Nada de esto hubiera pasado.
None of this would happen.
Nada de esto hubiera pasado.
None of this would happen.
Nada de esto hubiera pasado.
If you would just clean out your house.
Si hubiésemos limpiado nuestra casa.
But Israel liked, hey, she's 22.
Pero Israel estaba así. Ella
remember,
tiene 22.
Balaam and Balak tried to curse Israel.
Recuerda que Balaam y Balak estaban tratando de maldecir
a
Israel.
They built 21 altars.
Te hicieron 21 altares.
Are they able to curse Israel?
¿Ellos pudieron maldecir a Israel?
No. Nobody no. can curse Israel.
Nadie pudo maldecir a Israel.
What happens though?
¿Qué pasó entonces?
What happens in the next chapter?
¿Qué pasó en el próximo
Israel
capítulo?
Curses themselves.
Israel se maldice por
sí. They were looking at the women dancing around the pole.
Estuvieron
come here, guys.
Observando a las mujeres que
come
estaban
on, dance
bailando
with
en el
me.
Poste.
Come on. And they fell. Sexual temptation.
Y cayeron con una tentación sexual.
So here we fell to six different leaderships.
Aquí vemos que caímos en seis diferentes tipos de liderazgo.
Next slide, please.
La próxima página.
Okay, Persian rule. Just quick dates. We're going to do dates so you can understand what happened.
Vamos a hacer fechas.
Once again, this study is on the website.
Una vez más, este estudio está en.
Go to Messianic Student.
Vaya al discipulado mesiánico.
And look for Hanukkah.
Y mira por Hanukkah.
It's an 8-week study that I did.
Son 8 semanas de estudio que hicimos.
I'm just giving you the highlights tonight to get to the book of Maccabees.
Te estoy dando solo los encabezados para ir por medio del libro de los Macabeos.
Okay, Israel was ruled by the Persians.
Israel fue gobernado por Persia.
From 536 to 333 BC.
Desde 500
before Messiah.
536 al 333 antes del Mesías.
Okay? They had some good rulers, mostly bad rulers.
Tuvieron buenos gobernantes y la mayoría de ellos eran malos gobernantes.
Okay? The Persians allow Israel to have a high priest.
Los persos dejaron que Israel tenga un sumo sacerdote.
Okay, going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Then we enter into the Greek period.
Vamos ahora al periodo griego.
The Greeks only lasted 10 years.
Los griegos solo se demoraron, aguantaron 10 años.
The Greeks only, this is Alexander the Great's period.
Este es el periodo de Alexander the Great, el Grande.
Okay, and then we have the whole vision of Daniel in Daniel chapter 8 that happens during this period.
Y tenemos toda la visión de Daniel.
Not during this period, it was a period that Daniel talked about.
Es una visión que Daniel habla acerca de esto.
About the different regimes that would happen.
Acerca de diferentes regímenes.
Now we see the Hellenistic spirit really developing.
Vemos este régimen que está pasando.
Next slide. The Egyptian period lasts a lot longer than the Greeks.
Los egipcios duraron más que los otros.
The Egyptian period lasts from 323 to 204.
El período egipcio fue desde 323 hasta el 204.
Okay, we see. Okay, Alexander gets beaten.
Vemos que Alexander es golpeado.
Alexander's empire then breaks into four parts.
El imperio de Alexander se rompe en cuatro partes.
Some names that you might know is Ptolemy.
Los nombres que quizás tú reconozcas es
Lysimachus,
Ptolemy, Lysimachus,
Cassander, and Selenus.
Y Selenus.
Alexander's empire breaks into these four parts.
El imperio de Alexander se dividió en estas cuatro partes.
The reason I'm giving you all this, if you want to look it up, it really helps to understand history.
La razón por qué te estoy dando y quieras buscarlo, en verdad te ayuda a entender la historia.
But Ptolemy Soter is very harsh towards the Jews. He hates them.
El Ptolemy es bien duro con los judíos, él los odia.
But then his successor,
pero su sucesor,
Ptolemy Philadelphus, where we get the congregation of Philadelphia,
Ptolemy Philadelphus,
during his reign,
durante su periodo, su
they
reinado,
make the translation of the Septuagint into the Greek.
Hicieron la traducción de la Septuaginta al griego.
Okay, from Hebrew to the Greek language.
Del hebreo al griego.
Go on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Then the Syrians happen.
Después el periodo sirio
from
pasa.
204 to 165.
Desde el 204 al 165.
Okay, Antiochus the Great seizes opportunity in 204 and he invades Egypt and Judea.
Antíoco el Grande ve su oportunidad en el año 204 invadiendo a Egipto en Judea.
Okay, this is the first time Palestine is divided.
Esta es la primera vez que Palestina está siendo dividida.
It is now called Judea.
Es ahora llamado Judea.
Okay, Judea, there's five provinces.
Judea y sus cinco provincias.
Then he does Judea.
Que tiene Judea,
Samaria,
Samaria,
Galilee,
Galilea,
Perea, and Trachonitis.
Y Trachonitis.
Trachonitis. Going on to the next slide.
Próxima página.
The Syrian period is the most tragic part of for the Jews.
El período sirio es el período más trágico para los judíos.
Antiochus the Great is harsh towards the Jews.
Antíoco el Grande fue duro con los judíos.
But he is succeeded.
Pero su sucesor.
By the worst emperor ever.
Por el peor emperador que ha habido, que ha existido.
Antiochus Epiphanes reigns from 175 to 164.
Antíoco Epifanio desde 175 a 164.
And this is where the Maccabees raise up right after this.
Y es de aquí donde los macabeos se levantan después de esto.
During this time.
Durante este periodo.
The temple is desecrated.
El templo está siendo degradado.
The Torah is burned.
La Torah está siendo quemada.
Sacrifices are abolished.
Los sacrificios son abolidos.
All the gold in the temple is removed.
Todo el oro del templo está siendo removido.
There were pig sacrifices on our altar.
Había sacrificios de cerdos en el altar.
And the temple was rededicated to Jupiter.
Y el templo fue dedicado a Júpiter.
Jupiter Olympus.
A Júpiter Olimpo.
Which then, I said Zeus earlier, I'm sorry, that was an error.
Dije, Zeus, al principio, lo siento, fue un error.
Jupiter Olympus, or sometimes called Zeus, was erected on the altar in the most on the altar.
Well, Jupiter Olympus, quien fue fue erecto en un altar, puesto en un altar, en el altar.
And we're going to read what else happens in a few minutes.
Y vamos a leer qué pasó en unos minutos.
Then we go on to the next slide, the Maccabean period.
Vamos al periodo macabeo.
Okay. Antiochus provoked the Jews to revolt because God moved on their hearts.
Antíoco provocó a los judíos porque el Señor movió el corazón.
Judas succeeds his father Mattathias.
Judas sucedió a su padre Mattathias.
He gathered around him faithful fighters.
Se reunieron unos faithful fighters, fieles peleadores.
And on the 25th day of Kislev,
en el día 25 del mes de Kislev,
they consecrated the altar of God after winning it back.
Ellos consagraron el templo de Dios después de ganar la batalla.
That's why we're here tonight.
Es por eso que estamos aquí.
But don't worry, we're going to read what happens.
Pero no te preocupes, vamos a leer qué es lo que pasó.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
Okay, let's just skip this slide. Next slide after that. Then the Romans take over from 63 through 70.
Después, después los romanos toman este poder desde el año 63.
The Roman period begins in 63 before Messiah came to earth as a man.
El periodo romano empieza desde el año 63 antes que Yeshua venga como hombre.
Okay, Israel has the temple.
Israel tiene el templo.
But they're being run by Rome.
Pero es gobernado por Roma.
This is Pompey that is running it first.
Este es Pompeya, que era el gobernador.
Okay, his subjection of Jerusalem ended in Judea, and they began to reign independence.
Independent. Esto aquí es donde empezó a gobernar independientemente.
The high priest was completely deprived of his royal status.
El sumo sacerdote estaba completamente deprived,
taken away.
Se le fue quitado todo este poder real.
So when Yeshua's, remember when Yeshua's meeting with the high priest?
Cuando Yeshua se está reuniendo con el sumo sacerdote.
And Yeshua said, yes, Yeshua, are you the Messiah?
Y le pregunta a Yeshua, ¿eres tú el Mesías?
And Yeshua says, I am.
Y Yeshua dice, yo soy.
What does the high priest do?
¿Qué es lo que hizo el sumo sacerdote?
He rips his garments.
Él rasgó sus vestiduras.
Why?
¿Por qué?
Because he's not really a high priest.
Porque en verdad él no fue un sumo sacerdote.
He's a puppet. He's not even in the royal line.
Él es una marioneta.
He's
él no
not
sabe
in
las
Aaron's
leyes de
line.
Dios. Él no sabe las leyes de Dios. No es del linaje de Aarón.
But you only get this when you start to study history.
Y solo llegas a esto cuando empiezas.
You must incorporate studying massive amounts of history.
Tú debes incorporar estudiando historia.
Then you understand the New Testament a whole lot better.
Así vas a entender el Nuevo Testamento mejor.
Like, why did he rip his garments?
Tú dices, ¿por qué él se rasgó las vestiduras?
Because he really wasn't trained at all.
Porque en verdad él no fue entrenado.
He was a puppet of Rome.
Él fue una marioneta de Roma.
Sort of like our judges today that Obama has appointed.
Como muchos de los jueces hoy en día que Obama puso en el poder.
Let's move on to the next slide and skip that slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
I'll skip that. Let's get to what really happened, everybody.
Vamos a ver lo que en verdad pasó.
Has everybody understood a little bit? I went a little fast.
¿Entendieron? Fui un poco rápido.
But I wanted you to see what transpired and how it gets this way.
Pero lo que quiero que veas cómo esto sucedió para que veas esto.
And why Revelation 11 verse 10 is so important.
¿Y por qué Apocalipsis 11 versículo 10 es muy importante?
And why this morning's message was so important.
¿Y por qué el mensaje de la mañana fue importante?
How does it get this way?
¿Cómo llegamos a esto?
How does it get this way?
¿Cómo llegamos a esto?
When you let people take away the laws of God,
cuando dejas que la gente se apodere de las
leyes
de Dios,
then God gives you over to his enemies.
Entonces el Señor te entrega a sus enemigos.
That's why doing Hanukkah as a memorial is so important.
Es por eso que hacer Hanukkah como un día memorial es muy importante.
Let's read what happens.
Leamos lo que pasó.
We're in 1 Maccabees chapter 1 verse 11 through 15. Is that up on the screen?
Yes.
For those in Spanish, please look over here.
Para los que va a leer en español, por favor, miren a la pantalla.
Well, if you want to put a projector up, we can put a big screen real quick. You can't see it? Well, move up for you old people. What are your glasses, son? First Maccabees, chapter 1.
Primera de Maccabeos, capítulo 1.
Verse 11 through 15.
Versículo 11 al 15.
Remember, there are four reigns before this part.
Había cuatro reinados antes de esta
parte. They're in their fourth government between after Malachi.
Están en el cuarto gobierno antes de
Malaquías. Fourth pagan government.
Cuatro gobiernos paganos.
Verse 11 through 15.
Versículo 11 al 15.
This is First Maccabees.
Es Primera de Maccabeos.
It is not the Bible.
No es la Biblia.
It is a historical book.
Es un libro histórico.
That can be confirmed by other historians.
Que va a ser confirmado por otros
Just
historiadores.
Just so I'm clear with that, everybody.
Solo para clarificar eso.
Okay? In those days, certain renegades out of Israel and out from Israel and misled many, saying, "Let us go make a covenant with the Gentiles around us, for since we separated from them, many disasters have come upon us." This proposal seemed pleased them, and some of the people eagerly went to the king, who authorized them to observe the ordinances of the Gentiles. So they built the gymnasium in Jerusalem according to the Gentile custom and removed the marks of circumcision and abandoned the Holy Covenant and joined with the Gentiles and sold themselves to do evil. Amen? Verse 11.
Versículo 11.
They got some people saying, "Let's make a covenant with the Gentiles."
Está diciendo, hagamos un pacto con los gentiles.
And what else do they say in that verse?
¿Y qué más están diciendo en ese verso?
For since we separated from the Gentiles,
como nos separamos de los gentiles,
many disasters have come upon us.
Muchos desastres han venido a nosotros.
So you see where their focus is 100% wrong.
Tú ves en lo que se está enfocando es 100% erróneo.
No, you dingbats, it's because you left God.
No, es porque tú dejaste a Dios.
The Gentiles are not God.
Los gentiles no son
God's
Dios.
Jewish.
Dios es judío.
He made a covenant with you.
Él hizo un pacto contigo.
Look at verse 13.
Mira el versículo 13.
Then some of the people eagerly went to the king, who authorized them to observe the ordinances of the Gentiles. What would that be?
¿Qué sería esto?
What would that be?
¿Qué sería esto?
Everything pagan.
Todo pagano.
What would be that be, guys?
¿Qué sería esto?
Shrimp cocktail.
Cocteles de camarones.
Pig, 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 pig.
Cerdo, 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 cerdo.
Okay. Now verse 14.
Ahora,
wait, what else would the
14.
Ordinance of the Gentiles be?
¿Qué más sería de los,
what else
de
would the
gentiles?
Ordinance of the Gentiles be?
¿Qué más sería?
Sunday, worship of the son of sun god.
La adoración el domingo.
Worshipping Zeus.
Adorando a Zeus.
Worshipping Pan.
Adorando
worshipping all these other gods.
Adorando a todos los otros dioses.
Worshipping Satan himself.
Adorando a Satanás a sí mismo.
Now verse 14.
Ahora el versículo 14.
So they built a gymnasium in Jerusalem according to the Gentile custom. Amen?
Amen.
What's this Gentile custom?
¿Qué son estos costumbres paganos?
Everything is at the YMCA. Na, 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 na. Why am I gay? That's what was going on in that gymnasium, everybody.
Eso es lo que estaba pasando en ese gimnasio.
The gymnasium, you would go there and men would be naked with other men.
Y en el gimnasio estarías, los hombres estarían desnudos con otros hombres.
It was San Francisco before San Francisco was San Francisco.
Era San Francisco antes que San Francisco sea San Francisco.
It was homosexuality in Jerusalem.
Era la homosexualidad en Jerusalén.
It wasn't a gymnasium to go work out in.
No era un gimnasio donde ibas a ejercitarte.
It was a gymnasium to go work out in.
Era un gimnasio donde ibas.
In a bad way. Homosexuality.
Era homosexual.
Verse 15.
Versículo 15.
And removed the marks of circumcision, abandoned the Holy Covenant, and joined with the Gentiles, and sold themselves to do evil. Amen?
Amen.
How does one remove the marks of circumcision?
¿Cómo se van a remover la marca de la circuncisión?
You sew it back on.
Tú lo coses de vuelta.
Why? How would anybody know?
¿Cómo todos sabrían? ¿Cómo sabrían eso?
How would anybody know?
¿Cómo iban a saber?
Well, in that gymnasium while you guys were playing games.
En ese gimnasio donde estabas jugando.
While you guys were playing games.
Donde había juegos.
When you were playing what was then basketball. You didn't wear uniforms like the Giants or the Jets.
No se vestían uniformes como
the
los
Mets
gigantes
or the Yankees.
Or los Jets.
You all played the games naked.
Ellos tenían estos juegos y jugaban desnudos.
So when your thing was swapping around for everybody to see,
cuando todo lo que estaba al descubierto para que todo el mundo viera,
you all can see if he was circumcised or not.
Todos podían ver si estaba circuncidado o no.
So what else happens?
¿Qué más pasó?
So they say, let's sew it back on.
Dijeron, cosámoslo de nuevo.
We want to be just like the Gentiles.
Sería como los gentiles.
They abandoned the holy covenant of circumcision.
Ellos abandonaron el pacto de la circuncisión.
They sold themselves to do evil.
Ellos se vendieron para practicar la maldad.
What would that be, everybody?
¿Qué sería eso?
No Pesach.
No Hagmatzah.
No Bikurim. No Shavuot.
No Shavuot.
No Yom Teruah. No Yom Kippur. No Sukkot.
No Sukkot.
So God says, what, do you don't like me no more?
¿Qué dijo el Señor? No me quieres a mí más.
You like the Gentiles better than you like me.
A ti te gustan mejor los gentiles que yo.
Let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
1 Maccabees chapter 1 verse 20 to 24.
Primero libro de Macabeos capítulo 1 versículo 20 al 24.
After subduing Egypt, Antiochus returned in the 143rd year. He went up against Israel and came to Yerushalayim with a strong force. He arrogantly entered the sanctuary and took the golden altar, the lampstand for the light, and all the utensils. He took also the table, the bread of the presence, cups for drink, the bowls, the golden censer, the curtains, the crowns, the gold decorations in front of the temple, and he stripped it all off. He took the silver, the gold, and the costly vessels, took the hidden treasures he found. Taking them all, he went to his own land. He shed much blood and spoke with great arrogance. Amen. Why does this happen, everybody?
¿Por qué está pasando esto?
Why does this happen?
¿Por qué está pasando
esto?
If
our God is the king of all creation,
si nuestro Dios es el rey de toda la creación,
why would he allow this to happen in our house?
¿Por qué él permitiría que pase esto en nuestra casa?
Because you want to hang with the Gentiles.
Porque tú quisiste salir con los gentiles.
You want to be a Gentile.
Tú querías ser un gentil.
You want to sew on skin to, on top of your penis to fake that you're a Jew.
Tú querías poner otra piel en tus penes para dejar de ser judío.
Huh. What's most of the church doing tonight?
¿Qué es lo que la iglesia está haciendo? La mayoría de las iglesias hoy día.
Celebrating Christ Mass.
Están celebrando Misa de Cristo.
Selling themselves to the devil to do evil.
Están vendiéndose ellos a sí mismos al mal.
So when you sell yourselves to do evil,
cuando tú te vendes tú mismo para
God
hacer mal,
brings the pagan.
El Señor trae el pagano.
And look in verse 21, he arrogantly entered the sanctuary.
Mira, encontró la arrogancia, entró en el santuario.
He was able to take everything with not a problem at all.
Ellos pudieron coger todo sin ningún problema.
In verse 24, what happens?
En el versículo 24, ¿qué pasa?
He sheds much blood.
Derramó mucha sangre.
But I thought five of us will chase 100.
Pero yo pensé que cinco de nosotros iban a perseguir a 100.
I thought 100 of us will chase 10,000.
100 de nosotros iban a perseguir a 10,000.
That's only if God is with you.
Es solo si el Señor está contigo.
You can be ready for the fight all you want.
Tú puedes estar listo para pelear lo que tú quieras.
You can think you're young and strong.
Tú puedes ser joven y fuerte.
You can think you can fight good.
Tú puedes pensar que puedes pelear bien.
You think you can fight good.
Tú puedes pensar que puedes pelear
nothing.
Bien. Pero no eres nada.
Without the King of Kings behind you.
Sin el rey que esté tras tuyo.
You're nothing without God.
Tú no eres nadie sin Dios.
And they, everything's bad has been happening since we left the Gentiles.
Todo está mal desde que dejamos a los gentiles.
That's what's going on in Israel today.
Eso es lo que está pasando en Israel hoy en día.
We got to appease Obama.
Tenemos que complacer a Obama.
We got to make the Arabs happy.
Tenemos que hacer a los árabes felices.
No, you don't.
No necesitas.
You got to make dad
Tú
happy.
Necesitas hacer al padre feliz.
You got to make dad happy.
Que hacer feliz al padre.
That's what Hanukkah is about.
De eso se trata Hanukkah.
Let's see what happens next.
Veamos qué pasa después.
On the next slide, please.
La próxima.
1 Maccabees chapter 1.
Primera de Macabeos.
Verse 30 to 34.
Versículo 30 al 34.
Deceitfully he spoke peaceable words to them, and they believed him. But then suddenly fell upon the city, dealt it a severe blow, and destroyed many people of Israel. He plundered the city, burned it with fire, tore down its houses and surrounding walls. They took captive the women and children and seized the livestock. Then they fortified the city of David with great strong walls and strong towers, and it became their citadel. Amen. Remember in Matthew 24.
Recuerda Mateo 24.
What a terrible time it will be for women.
Qué tiempo terrible sería para las mujeres.
Why?
¿Por qué?
He's looking at 1 Maccabees chapter 1 verse 32.
Él estaba viendo el primero de Macabeos, capítulo 1, versículo 32.
Remember, it's recent history for Messiah.
Recuerda que era una historia reciente para el Mesías.
That's why in Hanukkah in John 10, 20, he's checking everything out.
Es por eso que en Hanukkah,
he's looking at everything.
Él está observando todo.
Verse 32.
Versículo 32.
They took captive the women and children and seized the livestock. Amen?
Amen.
This is why, ladies, you should always pray for the men of your congregation.
Es por eso que ustedes, damas, siempre deberían estar orando por los hombres de la congregación.
Without ceasing.
Sin cesar.
Why?
¿Por qué?
You in Bogotá.
Ustedes en Bogotá.
You should be praying for Pastor Ruben.
Deberían estar orando por Pastor Ruben.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
24 días a la semana, 7 días.
You should
a
be
la
praying
semana.
For me, 24 hours, 7 days a week.
Deberían estar orando por mí 24.
Especially
días
you ladies, because they'll kill me.
Porque si ellos me maten.
They'll kill me.
Ellos me matarán.
But no matter how ugly or fat or skinny you think you is.
No importa qué tan gordo o feo sean.
Don't worry.
No te preocupes.
A Muslim's still going to have sex with you no matter what you think you look like.
Un musulmán tendrá sexo contigo no importa cómo tú te mires, la apariencia que tengas.
When you get taken captive, ladies.
Cuando te lleven al cautiverio, mujeres.
That's why Boko Haram is so terrible.
Es por eso que Boko Haram es terrible.
That's why ISIS is so terrible.
Es por eso que ISIS es terrible.
That's why God is raising up these dumb, disgusting Muslims.
Es por eso que el Señor está levantando a estos tontos musulmanes.
Why?
Degradables. ¿Por qué?
Because we left him.
Porque lo abandonamos.
And ladies, you don't get to die fast.
Y mujeres, ustedes no van a morir rápido.
You're going to wish you were dead.
Tú vas a desear estar muerto.
But you can't commit suicide because that's murder of yourself. You won't be in heaven.
Pero no puedes suicidarte porque eso es matarte tú mismo y no vas a estar en el cielo.
You're going to have to live through it.
Vas a tener que vivir eso.
You don't want to live through it.
Tú no quieres vivir eso.
So when they took the women captive and the children,
cuando ellos llevaron cautivos a las mujeres y a los niños,
the Muslim men are raping little boys.
Los hombres están violando a los niños pequeños.
This is what's so important about Hanukkah.
Es por eso que es importante Hanukkah.
This altar.
Este altar.
This altar is so vitally important.
Este altar es bien tiene de mucha importancia.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
First Maccabees 1.
Primera de Macabeos 1.
Verse 35 through 40.
Versículo 35 al 40.
They stored up arms, food, collecting the spoils of Jerusalem. They stored them there and became a great menace. For the citadel became an ambush against the sanctuary, the evil adversary of Israel at all times. On every side of the sanctuary, they shed innocent blood. They defiled the sanctuary. Because of them, the residents of Jerusalem fled. They became a dwelling of strangers. She became strange to her offspring and her children. Forsook her. Her sanctuary became desolate like a desert. Her feasts were turned into mourning. Her Sabbaths into reproach. Her honor into contempt. Her dishonor now grew as great as her glory. Her exaltation was turned into mourning. Amen. All because you wanted to hang out with the Gentiles.
Todo porque quisiste estar con los gentiles.
Key verse is verse 37.
El versículo clave es el 37.
On every side of the sanctuary they shed innocent blood. They defiled the sanctuary. What kind of blood did they spill, everybody?
¿Qué tipo de sangre ellos derramaron?
Pig blood.
Sangre de
cerdo. Pig blood.
Sangre de cerdo.
They put it everywhere throughout the temple.
Ellos pusieron en todo lado del templo.
How did they defile it?
Cómo ellos lo contaminaron.
They had homosexual sex inside the sanctuary.
Tuvieron relaciones homosexuales de sexo dentro del santuario.
They had homosexual sex in the most holy place.
Tuvieron relaciones homosexuales en el lugar más santo. ¿Por qué?
Because we didn't want to repent.
Porque no quisimos arrepentirnos.
That's why Revelation 11 verse 10 is so important.
Es por eso que Apocalipsis 11 versículo 10 es importante.
How does it get this way?
¿Cómo llegamos a esto?
Because you love doing other things more than you love studying God's word.
Porque tú prefieres hacer otras cosas más que estudiar la palabra de Dios.
So what does that look at verse 39?
Que el versículo 39.
Her sanctuary became desolate like a desert. Her feasts were turned into mourning, her Sabbaths into reproach, her honor into contempt. Amen. God said, "You don't want me?"
El Señor dice, "Tú no me quieres."
I'm out of here.
Me voy de aquí.
I'm out of here.
Me voy de aquí.
You don't want my holy days? I'm out of here. I'm leaving.
No quieres mis fiestas? Me voy de aquí.
This is why Hanukkah is so important to read what it really is about.
Es por eso que es importante leer lo que en verdad pasó.
It's not, oh Hanukkah, oh Hanukkah, come light the menorah. Let's set a party, we'll all dance a horror. Gather around the table, I'll give you a treat.
No es de esto, no es
así. No. No. Absolutely not.
Absolutamente no.
It's to remind us.
Es para que nos recordemos
that my people,
que mi gente,
called by my name,
llamó mi nombre,
would humble themselves.
Se arrepintió.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
First Maccabees chapter 1 verse 41 to 61.
Primera de Macabeos capítulo 1 versículo 41 al 49.
Then the king wrote to the whole kingdom that all should be one people, that all should give up their particular customs. All the Gentiles accepted the command of the king. Many, even from Israel, gladly adopted his religion. They sacrificed to idols, profaned the Sabbath. The king sent letters and messengers to Jerusalem, the towns of Judea. He directed them to follow the customs strange in the land, to forbid burnt offerings and sacrifices, and drink offerings in the sanctuary, to profane the Sabbath and festival, to follow the sanctuary and priests, to build altars to sacred and sacred precincts and shrines for idols, to sacrifice swine and other clean animals, and to leave their sons uncircumcised, or to make themselves abominable by every unclean profane, so that they would forget the law and change the ordinance. Pause there. Pause at verse 49.
Para en el versículo 49.
Let's go over this.
Vamos por
so what happens next?
¿Qué es lo que pasa
the
después?
King sends letter.
El rey manda
like in
cartas,
the book of Esther,
en el libro de Esther,
that we should all be one people.
Que todos debemos ser una sola persona.
Like Nebuchadnezzar.
Como Nebuchadnezzar.
When you hear the flutes,
cuando escuches
las the lyre, everybody is to bow down, we're supposed to be one people.
Todos deberían postrarse, tenemos que ser un solo pueblo.
But many in Israel said, this sounds good, Christmas sounds nice.
Pero mucha gente dice que las Navidades suena bien.
Christmas sounds really nice. Put him a nice tree in
Navidad
our house.
Suena bien en Israel.
Call it a Hanukkah bush, my mother called it.
Se le llama un Hanukkah bush, un arbusto de Hanukkah.
Then look at verse 45.
Mira ahora el versículo 45.
They forbid burnt offerings, sacrifice, and drinks offerings in the sanctuary, profane the Sabbath and festivals. Amen? Amen. They stopped every Sabbath offering.
Ellos pararon toda ofrenda de Shabbat.
Then verse 47.
Después el versículo 47.
46-47. To defile the sanctuary and priests, they built altars and sacred precincts and shrines for idols, to sacrifice swine and other clean animals. This is what was happening in Jerusalem.
Esto es lo que estaba pasando en Jerusalén.
This is what Solomon started.
Esto es lo que Salomón empezó.
He started out good, everybody.
Eso empezó bien.
But then he married all these women.
Pero entonces se casó con
what, he had 700
mujeres.
Wives?
Tuvieron 700 esposas.
And the king is not supposed to. What did he put up?
Y el rey no debería haber hecho eso. ¿Qué es lo que?
Asherah poles.
Él puso los postes de Asherah.
What is an Asherah pole?
¿Qué es este poste?
A gigantic penis in Jerusalem.
Un pene gigante en Jerusalén.
This is what they were doing.
Eso es lo que estaban haciendo.
Sacred poles.
Postes.
Sacred
sagrados.
Shrines. And what did they do?
¿Y qué es lo que hicieron?
They sacrificed pigs.
Sacrificaron cerdos.
Every unclean animal in all of Israel.
Todo animal impuro en Israel.
Because they didn't want to follow God.
Porque no quisieron seguir a Israel. No quisieron seguir a Dios.
Next slide. Verse 50 through 56.
Versículo 53. 50 al 56.
Listen to this very closely, everybody.
Escucha esto.
He added, and whoever does not obey the command of the king shall die. In such words he wrote to the whole kingdom. He appointed inspectors over all the commands of the towns of Judah and to offer sacrifice town by town. Many of the people, everyone who forsook the law, joined them and did evil in the land. They drove Israel into hiding every place of refuge. Now the 15th day of Kislev, in the 145th year, they erected a desolating sacrilege on the altar of burnt offering. They built altars in the surrounding towns of Judah. They offered incense on the doors of the houses of the streets. The book of the law that they found were torn to pieces and burned in fire. Amen? Amen?
Amen.
So what happened?
¿Qué es lo que pasó?
The abomination that causes desolation.
Abominación que causa desolación.
This is what Yeshua was talking about, friend.
Y esto es lo que estaba hablando Yeshua.
Right there.
Verse
54.
Versículo 54.
Verse 54.
Versículo 54.
It already had happened.
Que ya pasó.
Okay? They built altars everywhere.
Construyeron altares en todo lado.
And what happened in verse 56?
¿Y qué es lo que pasa en el versículo 56?
The book of the law that they found, they tore to pieces and burned it in fire.
El libro de la ley que encontraron, lo rompieron y lo quemaron.
They took this book.
Tomaron este libro.
And burned it.
Y lo quemaron.
But everybody didn't care.
Pero a nadie le importó.
I'm sorry, I'm dying for this.
Lo siento, yo muero por esto.
You try to take my Bible, I'm going to put a bullet in your head.
Tratan de tomar mi Biblia, yo voy a poner una bala en
tu cabeza. I will have no problems emptying my clip into your body.
Yo no dudaría en aplastar el gatillo.
Not under my watch.
No, bajo mi.
That's what Yeshua was talking about, being a shepherd.
Eso es lo que Yeshua está hablando de ser un pastor.
Laying down your life for the sheep.
Dar tu vida por las ovejas.
That's what he's talking about before he celebrates Hanukkah.
De eso es lo que él está hablando antes de celebrar Hanukkah.
The hired hand will just let it happen.
Solo le dejaron que pase.
But he's talking about this.
Pero él está hablando de esto.
They burned the Torah.
Ellos quemaron la Torah.
They burned the other books of the law.
Ellos quemaron los otros libros de la ley.
They burned the Bible.
Quemaron la Biblia.
Let's now go on the next slide. 57 through 61.
Capítulos, versículos 57
First Maccabees chapter 1, verse 57 through 61.
Primera de Macabeos, capítulo 1, versículos 57 al 61.
Anyone found possessing the book of the covenant and anyone who adhered to the law was condemned to death by decree of the king. They kept using violence against Israel and against those who were found month after month in the towns. On the 25th day of the month, they offered sacrifice on the altar. It was on top of the altar of burnt offering. According to the decree, they put to death women who had their children circumcised, and their families, and those who circumcised them, they hung the infants from the mother's necks. All because you didn't want to follow the laws. All because you didn't want to follow the laws.
Todo porque no querían seguir la ley.
If you were found in possession of one of these,
si te encuentras en posesión de uno de estos,
they killed you.
Te van a matar.
Go ahead, make my day.
Ven, haz mi día.
As for me and my house,
pero por mí y mi casa,
the Lord.
Voy a servir al Señor.
And that's why we're talking about Hanukkah.
Y es por eso que estamos hablando de Hanukkah.
About rededicating our temples.
Acerca de rededicar nuestro templo.
That's why I brought Heidi and Ivana up.
Es por eso que traje a las dos mujeres aquí adelante.
I wanted you to see a pregnant woman.
Yo quería que vean a las dos mujeres embarazadas.
If you have your child circumcised, look what happens.
Si querías que tu hijo se circuncide, mira lo que pasaba.
Look at verse 61, everybody.
Mira el versículo 51.
And the families of those who circumcised them, and they hung the infants from the mother's necks.
Versículo 61.
They killed the father.
Le mataban al padre.
They killed the brothers.
Mataban a los hermanos.
And then hung the child around the mother's neck. How would you like that?
Y colgaban a los niños en el cuello de la madre.
This is coming, people.
Esto viene, esto se acerca.
If we don't turn.
Si no regresamos, si no retornamos.
Spin the dreidel. Oh Hanukkah, oh Hanukkah, come light the menorah. Let's have a party, we'll all dance the horror. Gather around the table, I'll give you a treat. Right. Great, guys.
Bueno, muchachos.
You jackasses.
Son payasos.
It's right there.
Está ahí.
Why is this so hard?
¿Por qué es tan duro?
You want a little Eli Shaver? Where's my granddaughter? She's sleeping? Where is she? Bring Elisheva. I want you to see the picture. That's why I teach like this.
Yo quiero que veas el panorama. Es por eso la imagen. Es por eso que yo enseño de esta manera.
Sarah will just cry. They hung the baby around the mother's neck.
Ellos le colgaban al bebé en el cuello de la madre.
They hung the baby.
Ellos colgaban al bebé.
Come here, Elisheva. And the papa. Come here, hon. Oh, I like your jammies. Come here, honey. And the papa again. My father never got to see one of these.
Mi padre nunca pudo ver a uno de ellos.
Not from my sisters.
Tampoco mis hermanas. No de mis hermanas.
Why is it so hard?
¿Por qué es tan
duro? Just do what God asks.
De solo hacer lo que el Señor pide.
If you do it for them,
si tú lo haces por ellos.
If you do it for the least of these, you do it for Yeshua.
Si tú haces por los más pequeños ellos, tú lo haces por Yeshua.
She doesn't know anything yet.
Ella no sabe nada todavía.
Atún.
Atún.
Can you say atún? Tuna. Imagine.
Imagínate.
Imagine, ladies.
Imagínate,
this was a little boy.
Que sería un niño varón.
And you wanted to follow the covenants.
Y tú quieres seguir los mandamientos.
Put a knife.
Ponerle un cuchillo.
They took their knives.
Insertarles un cuchillo.
Cut her neck.
Cortarle su cuello.
Because we wouldn't do what God said.
Porque no pudimos hacer lo que el Señor dijo.
We'll go back to mom. Go back to mom. Go to mom. You want to say with papa? Mm-hmm. Verse 60 and 61 again, everybody.
Versículo 60 y 61.
According to the decree, they put to death the women who had their children circumcised, and their families of those who circumcised them. They hung the infants around the mother's necks. They would let the baby die first around your neck.
Le dejaban que el bebé se muera cuando estaba colgado en el cuello.
Then they would kill you too.
Y después te mataban también.
So you got to see your child die, and it was all because of disobedience.
Tú podías ver al niño que se muere, y era todo por tu desobediencia.
This is why Yeshua is in the temple in John 10.
Es por eso que Yeshua está en el templo en Juan 10.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
First Maccabees chapter 2 now. Now we're going to get into the fight.
Primera de Maccabeos capítulo 2.
Can you take another half hour? 1 Maccabees chapter 2 verse 1 through 6.
Primera de Maccabeos capítulo 2 versículo 1 al 6.
In those days, Mattathias, son of John, son of Simeon, priest of the family of Jarib, moved to Yerushalayim and settled in Modin. He had 5 sons: John surnamed Gadi, Shimon called Thesai, Yehuda called Maccabeus, Eleazar called Avaron, and Yonatan called Aphis. He saw the blasphemies being committed in Yehuda and Yerushalayim, and he said, "Alas! Why was I born to see this? The ruin of my people, the ruin of the holy city, and to live there when it was given over to the enemy, the sanctuary given over to the aliens, her temple has become like a person without honor." He repeated what Esther said.
Repitió lo que Esther dijo.
What Mordecai said to Esther.
Lo que Mardoqueo le dijo a Esther.
You have been born for such a time as this.
Has nacido para tiempos como estos.
You can see Mattathias's heart.
Tú puedes ver el corazón de Mattathias.
Then he says, why am I seeing all these blasphemies?
Que dice que por qué estoy viendo todas estas blasfemias, estas injurias.
Why are we seeing all these blasphemies, people?
¿Por qué estamos viendo todas estas blasfemias?
Because of this.
Por esto.
You're not teaching your kids the word of God.
¿Por qué no enseñas a tus hijos la palabra de Dios?
Ask yourselves.
Pregúntate.
If you can go back,
si puedes regresar,
would you do things differently?
¿Harías las cosas de diferente manera?
Yeah, we would.
Sí, sí lo haríamos.
Go on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
1 Maccabees chapter 2, verse 15 through 18.
Primera Maccabees capítulo 2, versículo 15 al 18.
The king's officer who enforced the apostasy came to the town of Modin to make them an offer, make them offer sacrifice. Many in Israel came to them. Mattathias and his sons were assembled. Then the king's officer spoke to Mattathias as follows. You are a leader and honored and great in this town and supported by sons and brothers. Now be the first to come and do what the king commands as the Gentiles and the people of Yehuda and those that left Jerusalem have done. Then you and your sons will be numbered with the friends of the king. And you and your sons will be honored with silver and gold and many gifts. Amen? Amen. Be part of us and we'll give you money.
Una parte de nosotros el dinero?
Yes. Be part of us, we'll give you gold and silver.
Se parte de nosotros, vas a tener oro y plata.
The centurion says,
los centuriones dijeron,
the officer says,
dijeron,
come be a part of our posse. It's just,
ven y sé parte de nosotros.
Come on, everybody else will follow you.
Todos te seguiremos.
Everybody else will follow you.
Y todos te seguirán.
Do you lead to God?
¿Tú dejas a Dios?
Or do you lead to evil?
¿Tú los guías a Dios?
Do you lead to God?
¿Tú le guías a Dios?
Or do you lead to evil?
¿O tú los guías hacia el mal?
Be a leader, be honored in our town.
Sé un líder, sé un hombre de honor en nuestro pueblo.
Come celebrate Christmas with us.
Ven y celebra Navidad con nosotros.
Come celebrate Christmas with us.
Ven y celebra Navidad con nosotros.
Be part of us.
Sé parte de nosotros.
Those holidays are for the Jews.
Esos días son para los judíos.
We celebrate Christmas.
Nosotros celebramos Navidad. Have a shrimp.
Next slide. Verse 19 through 23.
Versículo 19 al 23.
But Mattathias answered in a loud voice, even if all the nations that live under the rule of king obey him, I have chosen to obey his commandments. Every one of them abandoning the religion of their ancestors, I and my sons and my brothers will continue to live by the covenant of our ancestors. Far be it from us to desert the law and the ordinances. We will not obey the king's words by turning aside from our religion to the right or to the left. When he had finished speaking these words, a Jew came forward in the sight of all to offer sacrifices on the altar of Modin according to the king's commands. Amen? Amen. So what does Mattathias do?
¿Qué es lo que estaba haciendo Mattathias?
He says, for me and my house.
Dice que por mí en mi casa.
He quotes Joshua 24.
Él cita Josué 24.
We're not going to go to the left or to the right.
No vamos a ir ni a la izquierda ni a la derecha.
As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord.
Por mí en mi casa vamos a servir al Señor.
Oh, what did Yeshua say in John 10?
¿Qué dijo Yeshua en Juan 10?
He's going to lay his life down.
Que él va a entregar su vida.
So he could pick it up again.
Así él puede recobrar otra vez.
Go to grandma. Hey, starting to sweat here. You're getting heavy, kid. You're getting big. What does Mattathias do?
¿Qué es lo que está haciendo Mattathias?
What does he do?
¿Qué él estaba haciendo?
He says, I'm going to choose the law.
Él iba a,
I'm going to choose the law.
A seguir la ley.
I'm going to obey God.
Voy a obedecer.
Everybody
a Dios.
Else is abandoning the covenant.
Todos están abandonando el pacto.
But it's the house of Beth Goim.
Pero en la casa de Beth Goim.
We're going to follow the commandments.
Vamos a seguir los mandamientos.
We're going to follow the commandments.
Vamos a seguir los mandamientos.
We're going to find the end of our talit. We're We're not going to follow the pagan rules.
No vamos a seguir las reglas paganas.
Somebody tells us we can't pray, we're going to pray louder.
Si alguien dice que no podemos orar, vamos a orar más alto.
Some fag tells me, you hurt my feelings, I say good.
Si algún gay te dice, estás hiriendo mis sentimientos, lo voy a decir,
I'm going to save your AIDS-infested body.
Te voy a salvar tu cuerpo que está infectado.
Oh, you can't say that. Well, I just did.
Pero no puedes decir lo que acabé de decir.
Because if asked for me in my house.
Porque es por mí y en mi casa.
My God said these things are bad.
Mi Dios dice que estas cosas son malas.
We don't want them in our society at all.
Y no los queremos en nuestra sociedad.
But look what happens.
Pero mira lo que pasa.
Well, look what happens in verse 23.
Mira lo que pasa en el versículo 23.
When he had finished speaking these words, a Jew came forward in the sight of all to offer sacrifice on the altar of Modin according to the king's command. Comes up and puts up his Christmas tree.
Venga y levantemos este árbol de Navidad.
Comes up and eats his ham sandwich, whatever it is.
Venga a comer este sándwich de jamón.
This Jew is not supposed to do this. We're supposed to be set aside.
Los judíos no están supuestos a hacer esto. Deben ser apartados.
Let's go to the next slide.
Próxima página.
Verse 24 to 29, please.
Versículo 24 al 29.
When Mattathias saw it, he burned with zeal, and his heart was stirred. He gave vent to righteous anger. He ran and killed him on the altar. The same time he killed the king's officer, who was forcing them to sacrifice. He tore down the altar, then burned with zeal for the law. And Phinehas did against Zimri, the son of Saul. Then Mattathias cried in the town in a loud voice, "Let everyone who is zealous for the law, who supports the covenant, come out with me." Then he and his sons fled to the hills and left all that they had in town. And at that time, many who were seeking righteousness and justice went down to the wilderness and lived there. What did we read in Matthew 24?
¿Qué leímos en Mateo 24?
Verse 15 to 20.
Versículo 15 al 20.
Yeshua is quoting this.
Yeshua está citando todo esto.
Yeshua is quoting this.
Yeshua está citando esto.
Let everyone who is zealous.
Deja que todo aquel que esté sea celoso.
Run to the hills.
Corran a las montañas.
And what did it say there?
¿Y qué es lo que dijeron?
They left everything. Don't get a coat. Don't get a coat.
Don't get your stuff. No recojan sus
Run
cosas.
Right now.
Corran ahora en ese momento.
This is why you got to study this.
Es por eso que debes estudiar todo esto.
Because it's going to happen again, because Yeshua said it would.
Porque va a pasar nuevamente, porque Yeshua dijo que va a pasar.
Oh Hanukkah, come light the menorah. Let's have a party, all dance a horror. Gather round the table, I'll give you a treat. Tiny tots of dreidels, candy to eat. And while they are playing, the candles are burning low. One for each night, we remember the light that was lost so long ago. Brilliant, guys. Nice song. It's to remember. 40 years ago, I can remember it.
40 años atrás, aún me sigo recordando esa canción.
45. Yeshua is pointing us to this.
Yeshua nos está apuntando a esto.
But Mattathias burned with zeal. Let's see what God does with Mattathias.
Mattathias, él se paró con celo. Vamos a ver lo que el Señor hace.
Because you might have to make the same decision, everybody.
Porque quizás tú estés en la misma posición.
Think about what you're going to do now.
Piensa qué es lo que vas a hacer ahora.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
1 Maccabees chapter 2, verse 30 through 33.
Primero de Macabeos, capítulo 2, versículo 30 al 33.
They, their sons, their wives, and livestock, because troubles pressed heavily upon them, and it was reported to the king's officer and the troops in Jerusalem, the city of David, that those had rejected the king's command had gone down to a hiding place in the wilderness. Many pursued them and overtook them, and camped opposite them and prepared for battle against them, on the Sabbath day. They said to them, "Enough of this. Come out and do what the king commands and you will live." Oh, what did it say?
¿Qué dijeron?
Matthew 24.
En Mateo 24.
Verse 20.
Versículo 20.
Pray that it doesn't happen on the Sabbath.
hora para que no pase en el sábado.
Why is Yeshua saying that?
Porque Yeshua está diciendo
esto. Oh, you're going to see what happens next.
Vas a ver lo que pasa después.
You're going to see what happens next.
Vas a ver lo que pasa después.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
Verse 34 to 37.
Versículo 34 al 37.
But they said, "We will not come out, nor will we do what the king commands, and so profane the Sabbath day." Then the enemy quickly attacked them, but they did not answer them, or hurl a stone at them, or block up their hiding place. They said, "Let us die in our innocence. Heaven and earth testify for us that you are killing us unjustly." Pray that it doesn't happen in winter or on Shabbat.
Ahora, para que no pase en invierno o en Shabbat.
Yeshua is pointing to Hanukkah, everybody.
Yeshua está apuntando a Hanukkah.
What happened to them?
¿Qué pasó con él?
Does God said we can't fight on the Sabbath?
¿Acaso el Señor dijo que no podemos pelear en el sábado?
No.
No dijo.
We can fight if somebody attacks us.
Podemos pelear si alguien nos ataca.
We're not going to attack on the Sabbath.
No vamos a atacarlos en el
sábado. But if we're attacked, you better believe I'm going to plug your body full of bullets.
Pero si nos atacan, tú vas a ver que
now,
si
why
voy
waste
a,
bullets? I'm going to use them sparingly on your brain.
Voy a atacarte.
But these people.
Pero esta gente.
These people said, "Let us die in our innocence."
Déjanos morir en
idiots.
Innocencia. Idiotas.
Idiots. But why are they idiots?
¿Por qué son idiotas?
Why are these people idiots?
¿Por qué esta gente fue
why
idiota?
Are these Jewish people idiots?
¿Por qué esta gente judía fue idiota?
What did I talk to you about?
¿De qué te hablé?
Hellenistic.
Helenismo.
Hellenistical.
Helenismo.
They forgot the word of God.
Ellos se olvidaron la palabra
they forgot
de Dios.
To teach their children the word of God.
Se olvidaron de enseñar a sus hijos la palabra de Dios.
So now they're trying to come back, but they don't know how to come back.
Ahora
it's
están
like
tratando
a
de regresar, pero no saben cómo regresar, como los cristianos.
Oh, we're going to die in our innocence. Yeah, you're going to die in your stupidity, and no, you're not getting into heaven.
Vamos a morir en nuestra inocencia. Sí, vas a morir en tu estupidez y no vas a llegar al cielo.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
Verse 42 to 48. 1 Maccabees chapter 2 verse 42 to 48.
Primer de Maccabeos capítulo 2 versículo 42 al 48.
Then there united with them a company of Hasdeans, mighty warriors of Israel, who had offered themselves willingly for the law. And all who became fugitives to escape their troubles joined them and reinforced them. They organized an army and struck down the sinners in their anger and renegades in their wrath. The survivors fled to the Gentile cities for safety. Mattathias and his friend went around and tore down the altars. They forcibly circumcised all the uncircumcised boys that they found within the borders of Israel. They hunted down the arrogant, and the work prospered, and the work prospered in their hands. They rescued the law of the hands of the Gentile and kings. They never let the sinner gain the upper hand. Amen? Amen. So what happens? Mattathias gains in power.
Entonces, ¿qué pasa? Mattathias llega al poder.
They started to kill people, Jews.
Empezaron a matar a los
Jews
judíos.
Jews are now killing Jews.
Los judíos no matan a judíos.
Who would not follow the laws of God.
Quienes no siguen la ley de Dios.
But what did the Jews do?
¿Qué es lo que hicieron los judíos?
Who don't want to follow the law.
Quienes no querían seguir la ley.
They run away from Mattathias, the Maccabees.
Ellos se alejaron de Mattathias.
They'd rather be with the pagan Gentiles.
Ellos prefirieron estar con los paganos gentiles.
There are many Jews that have come to this congregation.
Muchos judíos que han venido a esta congregación.
Like Marty Goetz, the song we sang earlier.
Como Marty Goetz.
Would not feel comfortable in this congregation.
La canción que cantamos temprano, él no se sentiría.
I know Marty for 20 years.
Él no se sentiría bien en esta congregación.
I've lost most of my Messianic friends.
Yo lo conozco él por más de 20 años.
They
yo
would
perdido,
rather celebrate Christmas.
Yo he perdido a lo más de mis amigos mesiánicos.
What is the dingbat John Conn doing tonight?
¿Qué está haciendo Jonathan Conn?
Messiahmas.
La misa del Mesías.
Great bubblehead.
Grande.
Great. Okay. That's exactly what we need.
Eso es exactamente lo que necesitamos.
But here. The Maccabees.
Pero aquí los Macabeos.
You might find this is harsh, but it has to be. You might find this a little harsh.
Quizás esto lo encuentres un poco duro.
I'm reading you what happened and what Yeshua was pointing to.
Te estoy leyendo lo que pasó y lo que Yeshua está apuntando
aquí. It's coming. Trump is better than the other idiot that's in the White House.
Trump es mejor que el otro idiota que está en la Casa Blanca.
But Trump is not a godly man.
Pero Trump no es un hombre de Dios.
He's just an ice cream of a different flavor.
Él es solo un helado de diferente sabor.
Now, if he really gets saved, amen.
Si en verdad se llega a ser salvo, amén.
He's not bigger than God, and our God is bigger.
Él no es grande, más grande que Dios. Nuestro Dios es más
but
grande.
But if history is sure, and it is.
Si la historia es cierta y lo es.
When you stand for God,
cuando te paras por Dios,
and you stand for His ways,
cuando te paras por sus caminos,
He raises you up.
Él te eleva.
He blesses your house.
Él bendice tu casa.
He blesses your family.
Él bendice tu familia.
Let's see what happens next. Next slide.
Vamos a ver qué pasa.
First Maccabees chapter 2, verse 50 through 61.
Primera de Macabeos, capítulo 2, versículo 50 al 61.
Now, my children, show zeal for the law and give your lives for the covenant of our ancestors. Remember the deeds of our ancestors, what they did in their generations, and you receive great honor and everlasting name. Was not Abraham found faithful when tested? And was not it reckoned to him as righteousness? Joseph, the time of the distress, kept the commands and became lord of Egypt. Phinehas, the ancestor, our ancestor was deeply zealous and received the covenant of everlasting priesthood. Yehoshua became, because he was filled with the command, became judge of Israel. Caleb, because he testified in the assembly, received an inheritance of the land. David, because he was merciful, inherited the throne of the kingdom forever. Elijah, because of a great zeal for the law, was taken up into heaven. Hananiah, Azariah, Mishael believed that they were saved from the flame. That Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Daniel, because of his innocence, was delivered from the mouth of the lions, and so observant from generation to generation that none of those who put their trust in him lack strength. Amen.
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 Now be zealous for the law of God, he says.
Ten celo por la palabra de Dios.
I can't do it.
Yo no puedo hacerlo.
I can't do it.
No puedo hacerlo.
I'm missing Christmas so much.
Yo extraño la Navidad.
What's
mucho.
My family gonna think now?
¿Qué va a pensar, mis amigos?
Oh, what are you, a Jew now?
Ahora, ¿qué piensas? ¿Eres un judío ahora?
Next slide. First Maccabees chapter 3 now.
Primer libro de Macabeos, capítulo 3 ahora.
Verse 10 through 12.
Versículo 10 al 12.
You don't think the government's going to stand down on this one, do you?
No piensas que el gobierno se va a parar por
so
esto,
let's
¿verdad?
See what happens with the devil.
Veamos qué pasa.
Apollonius now gathered together Gentiles and a large force from Samaria to fight against Israel. When Judas learned of it, he went out to meet him and defeated and killed him. Many were wounded and fell, and the rest fled. Then they seized their spoils. And Judas took the sword of Apollonius and used it in battle the rest of his life. Amen? Amen. He took his enemy's sword.
Tomó las espadas de sus enemigos.
And used it against them.
Y los usó en contra de ellos.
That's what we're supposed to do.
Eso es lo que deberíamos
we're
hacer.
Using the internet, which is used for bad purposes.
Nosotros utilizamos el internet que está siendo ocupado para
we
propósitos
are using
malos.
It for good.
Estamos utilizando para
right
algo
now,
bueno.
People in Bogotá, Colombia are receiving a Hanukkah message.
Ahora la gente en Colombia está recibiendo un mensaje de Hanukkah.
But most people use the internet for YouTube University.
Pero mucha gente utiliza el internet para la universidad de YouTube.
Most people use the internet for pornography.
Mucha gente utiliza el internet para pornografía.
But we're using it for good. We're using the enemy's tool against him.
Estamos nosotros utilizando para algo bueno. Estamos utilizando la herramienta del enemigo para ir en contra de él.
Next slide.
Próxima.
Verse 16 through 19 now.
Versículo 16 al 19.
When he approached the ascent of Beth Horon, Yehuda went out to meet him with a small company. But when they saw the army coming to meet him, they said to Judas, how can we, few as we are, fight against so great and strong a multitude? And we're faint. We haven't eaten nothing today. Judas replies, it is easy for many to be hemmed in by few. For in the sight of heaven, there is no difference between saving by many or by few. It is not the size of the army that victory is in battle. Depends on the strength that comes from heaven. Amen?
Amen.
It is not the size of our army, everybody.
No es la cantidad del ejército.
It is not by power.
No es por poder.
It is not by might.
No es por mente.
It is by my spirit,
es por mi
saith
espíritu,
Lord.
Dice el Señor.
But we haven't eaten.
Pero no hemos comido.
And we're tired.
Y estamos cansados.
And they got all this equipment, and we got
Ellos tienen todo ese, ese equipo.
They got esa, guns.
Ellos tienen pistolas.
And we got pocket knife.
Y nosotros tenemos una navajita.
So what does Maccabees say? What does Judas say?
Una navaja de bolsillo. ¿Qué es lo que dice Judas?
What does Judas say?
¿Qué dice Judas?
It's not the size of the army that matters, guys.
Dice que no debe importar el número de soldados.
It's the strength that comes from heaven.
Es de la fuerza que viene del cielo.
Next slide. Verse 27 to 31 now.
Versículo 27 al 31.
When King Antiochus heard these reports, he was greatly angered. He sent and gathered all the forces of his kingdom, a very strong army. He opened the coffers and gave a year's pay to his forces in order for them to be ready for any need. Then he saw the money of the treasury exhausted, and that the revenues from the country were small because of the dissension and disaster that he caused in the land, abolishing the laws that existed from earlier days. He feared that he might not have such funds that he had before in expenses and gifts that he used to give more than lavishly in preceding kings. He greatly perplexed in his mind, and he determined to go to Persia to collect revenues from those regions and raise a large fund. Amen? So now he's getting his butt kicked.
Ahora él está siendo pateado su trasero.
He gives the army a year's pay.
Le da al ejército un año de salario.
And he's getting ready to go against Israel.
Él se está listando para ir en contra de Israel.
And crush the Maccabees.
Y aplastar a los Macabeos.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
Verse 38 to 40 now.
Versículo 38 al 40.
Lysias chose Ptolemy, son of Dorymenes, and Nicanor, and Gorgorius, able men among the friends of the king. And he sent with them 40,000 infantry and 7,000 cavalry to go to the land of Judah to destroy it. The king had commanded. So they went out with their entire force, and when they arrived in the camp near Emmaus in the plain. Amen?
Amen.
So here you got 40,000 marching soldiers.
Aquí tenemos 40,000 soldados de infantería.
7,000 cavalry.
Y 7,000 de caballería.
Against the Maccabees.
En contra de los Macabeos.
Who have a knife.
Quienes tenían una navaja.
This is not going to turn out very well, don't you think?
Esto no va a terminar en algo bueno. ¿No piensas eso?
40,000.
40,000.
Judas.
Judas.
Look.
Mira.
She's not 22. There's 40,000.
No tiene 22. Son 40,000 ahí.
No. 47.
47.
Look at all the horses.
Mira todos los caballos.
Look at. It's not the size of the army.
No es el porte del ejército.
Not by power.
No por poder.
Not by might.
No por poder.
But by my spirit, says the Lord.
Mi espíritu dice el Señor.
Let's see what goes on next. Next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Let's look at verse 46 to 48 now.
Versículo 46 al 49.
They gathered together and went to Mitzpah, opposite Yerushalayim, because Israel formerly had a place of prayer in Mitzpah. They fasted that day, put on sackcloth, and sprinkled ashes on their heads and tore their clothes. Then he opened the book of the law to inquire into those matters about which the Gentiles consulted the likeness of their gods. They also brought the vestments and the priesthood and the first fruits and tithes, and they stirred up the Nazarites who had completed their days. Amen? So what did they do?
Entonces, ¿qué hicieron?
What did they do now?
¿Qué es lo que hicieron ahora?
They said, we got to pray.
Dijeron, tenemos que orar.
We got to ask God for favor, man.
Tenemos que pedir al Señor, por favor.
They put on sackcloth and ash.
Se pusieron ceniza.
Well, whatever it says in
Cilicio.
Verse 47.
Cilicio.
Okay? And then they brought out what? They brought out the priesthood.
Y ellos trajeron al sacerdocio.
Because who were the Hasmoneans?
Pero ¿quién es el que?
Hasmoneans.
Hasmoneans.
We read about them. This Hasmoneans. It's a Jewish word.
Oh, okay.
Hebrew word.
¿Quién era Hasmoneans?
They were the priests.
Ellos fueron los sacerdotes.
They were the priests.
Fueron los sacerdotes.
So they brought out the vestments and what they should do.
Y trajeron las vestiduras. ¿Y qué es lo que hicieron?
What did they do?
¿Qué hicieron?
What is in the vestments?
¿Qué estaba en las vestiduras?
The Umim and the Tumim.
El Umim y el Turim.
What would God say when they rolled the dice?
¿Qué es lo que dijo el Señor cuando ellos botaron los dados?
47,000 against a not too big of an army.
47,000 en contra de un ejército no muy grande.
Next slide.
Próxima.
Now first Maccabees chapter 4.
Primer libro de Maccabeos capítulo
4. Verse 1 to 3 because they win that battle.
Versículo 1 al 3 porque ganaron la
batalla. They win that battle, everybody. They win that.
Ganaron la batalla.
And now next comes another battle.
Después viene otra batalla.
Verse 1, 2, and 3 now.
Versículo 1, 2, y 3.
Now Gregorius took 5,000 infantry and 1,000 picked cavalry, and this division moved out by night to fall upon the camp of the Jews and attack them suddenly. Men from the citadel were the guides, but Judas heard of it, and his warriors moved out to attack the king's force in Emmaus. Why is the road to Emmaus so important?
¿Por qué es la ruta de Emmaus importante?
Because when things get revealed on the road to Emmaus.
Porque las cosas fueron reveladas en la ruta de Emmaus.
Remember after Messiah is crucified and died and is in the grave?
Recuerda después que el Mesías resucitó y
and he raises from the grave?
El resucitó de la tumba.
Where does he meet them?
¿En dónde
on the road to Emmaus?
En la ruta a Emmaus.
Why is he doing that?
¿Por qué él está haciendo
right
esto?
Here. He reveals things on the road to Emmaus.
Él revela cosas en la
so this guy's sneaking around with 5,000.
Este hombre está.
I don't know how well you can sneak around with 5,000 men.
No sé cómo te puedes tú
walk softer.
Mover escondido con 5,000.
The horses. How do you keep the horses quiet?
¿Cómo mantienes a los caballos en silencio?
Put this on. Here, horsey. Not too brilliant.
No, muy brillante.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
Verse 26 to 35, 31 now.
Versículo 26 al 31.
They win that battle, everybody.
Ellos ganaron esa batalla.
Then the foreigners who escaped went to report it to Lysias, and all that happened. When he heard it, he was perplexed and discouraged, for things had not happened to Israel as he had intended. Nor had they turned out the way the king ordered. But the next year, he mustered 60,000 picked infantry and 5,000 cavalry to subdue them. They came into Idumea and encamped at Bethzur. And Judas met them with 10,000 men. When he saw their army was strong, he prayed, saying, "Blessed are you, O Savior of Israel, who crushed the attack and mighty warrior by the hand of our servant David, gave the camp to the Philistines to hand to Yonatan, the son of Shaul, and the people who carried his armor. Hem in this army and hand of your people, Israel, and let them be ashamed of their troops and their cavalry." Amen?
Amen.
How many?
¿Cuántos?
60,000 infantry.
Soldados
and 5,000 cavalry against what?
Y 5,000 de caballería.
6.5 to 1.
En contra de 10,000 hombres.
Oh.
6.1.
How many nations came against Israel?
¿Cuántas naciones vinieron en contra de
when
Israel?
She became a modern nation?
Cuando se convirtió en una nación moderna.
6 to 1.
6 a 1 contra 1.
60,000 infantry, that's not going to go well.
60,000 de infantería.
They had 60,000 infantry with bayonets.
Tenían 60,000 de infantería con
bayonetas.
Con bayonetas.
Against the Maccabees.
En contra de los Macabeos.
This is not going to turn out well.
Eso no se va a llevar algo bueno. No va a terminar bien.
Oh Hanukkah, come light the menorah. Have we seen anything about a menorah? Have we read anything about a menorah?
Hemos leído algo de la menorah?
We've read about a lot of battles.
Hemos leído acerca de muchas batallas.
Mahonso, Yeshua ti. That's what he's singing about.
Es lo que cantamos. Oh.
65,000 to 10,000, I don't think that's going to go well at all.
60,000 y en contra de 10,000.
Let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Verse 26, verse 32 to 35, please, now.
Versículo 32 al 35.
Fill them with cowardice, melt their boldness, their strength, let them tremble in their destruction, strike them down the sword of the sword of those who love you, and let them know your name, praise you with the hymns. Then both sides attacked, and they fell on the army of Lysias, 5,000 men. They fell in action. When Lysias saw the rout of his troops, he observed the boldness and what inspired those from Judas, and how ready they were either to live or die nobly. He withdrew to Antioch and enlisted mercenaries in order to invade Judea again with an even larger army. Amen? So the Maccabees destroy this army.
Los Macabeos destruyeron este ejército.
Because it's not by power.
Porque no es por poder.
It's not by might.
No por mente.
It's by my spirit,
es
says
por
the Lord.
Mi espíritu, dice el Señor.
Let's see what happens now.
Ahora veamos qué pasa.
Let's go to the next slide, verse 36 to 42.
Vamos a la próxima página, versículo 36
now
al 42.
We're going to get to Hanukkah.
Ahora vamos a llegar a Hanukkah.
But you had to understand what happened.
Pero debías entender qué es lo que pasó.
Then Judas and his brothers said, See, our armies are crushed. Let us go up and cleanse. See, their armies are crushed. Let us go up and cleanse the sanctuary and dedicate it. So all the army assembled went up to Mount Zion. And they saw the sanctuary desolate, the altar profaned, the gates burned. In the courts they saw bushes sprung up in the thicket or as one of the mountains. They saw the chambers of the priests in ruins. They tore their clothes and mourned with great lamentation. They sprinkled themselves with ashes and fell on their face down on the ground. And when the signal was given with the trumpets, they cried out to heaven. Then Judas detailed men to fight against those in the citadel until they had cleansed the sanctuary. He chose blameless priests devoted to the law. Amen? So after they beat the 65,000,
después de que golpearon los 65,000,
they killed 5,000.
Mataron a 5,000.
And the rest tucked their tail and ran away.
Y los otros se corrieron.
Now they come up to the sanctuary.
Ahora llegan al santuario.
And they see how it has been profaned.
Y vieron cómo fue, ha sido profanado.
Let's go to the next slide.
Próxima página.
Verse 43 to 51.
Versículo 43 al 51.
And they cleansed the sanctuary and removed the defiled stones to an unclean place. They deliberated what to do about the altar of burnt offering, which had been profaned. They thought it best to tear it down, so it would not be a lasting shame to them that the Gentiles had defiled it. So they tore down the altar and stored the stones in a convenient place on the temple hill until the prophets should come and tell what to do with them. They took unhewn stones, as the law directs, and built a new altar like the former one. They also rebuilt the sanctuary in the interior of the temple and consecrated the courts. They made new holy vessels and brought the lampstand, the altar of incense, and the table into the temple. They offered incense on the altar and lit the lamps on the lampstand and gave light to the temple. They placed the bread on the table and hung the curtain. They finished all the work that they had undertaken. What did they do?
¿Qué es lo que hicieron?
They tore down the defiled altar.
Ellos destruyeron el altar que estaba contaminado.
And put a new altar up.
Y pusieron un nuevo altar.
They lit the menorah.
Ellos encendieron la menorah.
They didn't say, well, we don't have enough oil for the menorah.
Ellos no dijeron, no tenemos aceite para la menorah.
We don't have enough oil for 8 days.
No tenemos aceite para 8 días.
They lit the menorah.
Ellos encendieron la menorah.
They gave light to the temple.
Para dar luz al templo.
Go on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
52 to 59.
52 al 59.
This is why we're doing Hanukkah.
Es por eso que estamos haciendo Hanukkah.
Early in the morning on the 25th day of the ninth month, which is today, which is the month of Kislev, 148th year, they rose and offered sacrifice as the law directs on the new altar of offering that had been built. And at the very season and the very day the Gentiles profaned it, it was dedicated with songs and harps, lutes and cymbals. All the people fell on their faces and worshiped and blessed heaven. who prospered them. So they celebrated the dedication of the altar 8 days and joyfully offered burnt offerings and offered sacrifices of well-being and thanksgiving offerings. They decorated the front of the temple with gold crowns, small shields, and restored the gates and the chambers of the priests. They fitted them with doors. There was a very great joy among the people, and the disgrace brought by the Gentiles was removed. Then Judas and his brothers and all the assembly of Israel determined that every year at the seasons of the day of dedication of the altars should be observed with joy and gladness for 8 days, being the 25th day of the month of Kislev. Amen?
Amen.
That is today.
Eso es hoy día.
That is today.
Es hoy día.
Why did they win, everybody?
Porque ellos ganaron.
Because they dedicated their hearts to God.
Porque ellos dedicaron sus corazones al Señor.
Why did they rededicate the temple?
Porque rededicaron el templo.
How did they rededicate the
¿Cómo
temple?
Lo hicieron? ¿Cómo rededicaron
Who
el templo?
Allowed them to rededicate
¿Quién
the temple?
Permitió que redediquen el templo?
Our God.
Nuestro Dios.
Because why?
¿Por qué?
Because if my people
Porque si mi gente
were called by my name
llaman mi nombre,
would humble themselves
y se humillan,
and turn from their wicked ways
y regresan de sus caminos malvados,
then I would hear from heaven
entonces escucharé del cielo,
and heal their land.
Y sanaré su
Amen.
Tierra.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
This is why we celebrate Hanukkah.
Esto es como se celebra Hanukkah.
Because it's all about
Porque se trata
John 10,
de Juan 10,
verse 22 and 23.
Versículo 22 y 23.
This is what the Messiah was doing.
Eso es lo que el Mesías estaba haciendo.
He was seeing if there was anybody
Él estaba viendo si hay alguien
that would want to teshuva.
Que quería retornar.
Hanukkah is about your altars.
Hanukkah es acerca de tus altares.
Today is the day
Hoy día es el día
that we rededicate our lives to God.
Que rededicamos nuestras vidas a Dios.
Today is the day
Hoy día es el día.
That we rededicate this altar.
Que rededicamos este altar.
Today is the day.
Hoy día es el día.
The 25th day of the month of Kislev.
El día 25 del mes
that
de
Yeshua
Kislev.
Points to.
Que Yeshua está apuntando.
In Matthew 24.
En Mateo 24.
Don't let it happen in our time.
No dejes que pase en nuestro
Because
tiempo.
It is not by might.
Porque no es por mente.
It is not by power.
No por poder.
But by the Spirit.
Pero por el Espíritu.
Says the Lord.
Dice el Señor.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Why don't we do Maotzor? Why don't we all rise? You would be so kind, Tristan, to come back out here and put Maotzor back on the screen. Now you understand why he wanted to do it. We're just going to do the Hebrew.
Samson's on. Tap.
Two. Turn on the reverb. Guitar, please. Okay. Let's end this dedication day with the words of Rock of Ages. We're going to just do the Hebrew. Well, maybe we'll do a little nicer version of the English. Bass. Bass. Can you put it up on the screen, please, Tristan? I took it down. Escape out of this project.
to close it. Bass. Hanukkah is about God defending us, about God being with us.
We thank you, Lord. Why don't we just bow our hearts? Lord of all creation, to all power and glory belong to you. You are so wonderful, magnificent. May this place, Beth Goyim, bring just a little smile to your face. May the words that come from this pulpit bring joy to your heart. This place stands for you, Yeshua, and the word that your Father gave us. We stand for the dedication of your altar. We're small. We have no power. But we give all praise and honor to and glory to you, because you are the power. Yeshua, thank you so much for walking around that temple that day to give us a view into your heart. This day, we all come together. We ask for a heart of flesh now. As you told your prophet Ezekiel, to give us a heart of flesh. We pray that you would hear our cries tonight and that you would give us all a heart of flesh. That this praise offering to you, this thanks offering to you, would make you happy. That is our goal, to please you, because Yeshua, we love you. Ahava. Amor. We love you with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength. Take this place and use it for your glory. As the new president sits right across the river, may he come walking through these doors. May I not shrink back, but give him the truth of what a great honor it is to be a leader of this great nation that was dedicated to you long ago. We ask for that in Israel also, that they would turn from man-made ways, from homosexuality, from stealing, criminal activity, and all the bad things that are going on there. And that you would speak to each and every leader of that country and let them know that you're still on your throne. And that if your people who are called by your name would humble themselves, then you would hear from heaven on this Hanukkah and heal their land. That they wouldn't have to count on us, that you would be their protector. Let them dedicate their lives to you, Father, and to your magnificent, incredible Son, our Mashiach. Your name Yeshua, I pray. And everybody said, Amen. Amen.
Shalom. This is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to the Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. And click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
If you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us, and He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
Shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift his face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you his shalom.
Shalom. My name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. BGMC is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the Book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7. That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture. Truly, the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend a day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures, searching for clues to understand what they mean, and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into his eternal word. Not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of his kingdom become accessible to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there. Because Shabbat is so special to him, there is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close this Shabbat together with a reading of the new week's parasha. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.